Hello and welcome to the third stop of the World Skateboarding Tour 2023 here in the Olympic city of Lausanne. It's finals day and we have the top eight women and top eight men coming through from semi-finals, and they are going head to head on this custom built incredible course for their place on today's podium. Our last event was in the ancient city of Rome, but now we are on the beautiful shore of Lake Geneva to continue the legacy of skateboarding competitions in Lausanne. I'm Mark Churchill, and I'm very happy to say that joining me on the platform is an absolute skateboard legend, artist, and co-founder of Stereo Skateboards, Mr. Chris Pastras.
Thank you, sir. I appreciate that, Mark. I've been coming to Switzerland since the early 90s with demos and contests, and I gotta say, this has always been like a gem of a location. The stands are jam-packed, the fans are going nuts, and the level of skateboarding is insane. Excited for this final.
Coming up over the next couple of hours, we have all the action from women's and men's finals. We catch up with Simon Stricker to talk about skating in Switzerland. And we are going to check in with Aurelien Giraud, Nyjah Huston, Gustavo Ribeiro and Rayssa Leal to take a look back at our last event in Rome and their ambitions for Lausanne. And also stay up to date with everything skateboarding on the World Skate Instagram at WorldSkateSB. Not only am I joined by one legend, Chris Pastras, but there's another one on the platform with me and an absolute skate icon. I'd like to welcome Eric Coston. Thanks for being here, Eric.
Hey, I'm happy to be here. It's nice. Nice to be back.
What's it like to be back here after 20 years?
It's a beautiful place. I miss it. I can't believe it's been 20 years, you know, since the Grand Prix of skateboarding back in the day.
And you know those Yeah, times. I remember. You won 98. We have footage of it. And I got to say, the level of skateboarding, Eric, that we've seen since 20 years ago.
It's insane. After watching yesterday, even that was the semifinals, the cutting it to eight, I was like, that's not fair. There's too many good skateboarders. But the progression level has gotten out of hand.
And there we saw your winning run from 1998.
See, I told you I won. You didn't believe me. No. Actually, I forgot I won that contest. But no, all seriousness aside, these guys and girls, the consistency, the level is—it's beyond.
Yeah.
How hard they push themselves. The caliber of trick and to be able to do it on the fly on that with that kind of pressure. Yeah. It's intense.
And not to put you on the spot, but any favorites?
Vacation.
Any favorites out there?
I've always got my homies. You know, Yuto. Jaw, obviously. Jaw put up one hell of a performance yesterday.
Yes.
Holding down that first spot. Yeah. You know what? Richard Turi, too. He's always in there just grinding it out.
Amazing.
Yeah, he's on it. But what are the differences that you see out here on the course than back in 20 years ago?
Gosh, I don't know. The stakes are higher. The stakes feel a little bit higher. You know what I mean? We're having fun. It was free flowing. To some degree, some of these guys are out here and trying to have fun too. They need to, because if they take this thing too serious, it's going to apply too much pressure. It's going to make it harder to skate.
Yeah, massive shout out to Transworld for hooking us up with the footage. Definitely scan that QR code and check out the 411 store. What do you think some of the biggest changes are since 20 years ago, since the last time you were here within skateboarding?
Like I'm going back to the level of progression and how fast, and even since the Olympics have come into the picture, and this new crop of even more gnarly skateboarders, men and women, that keep just popping out of nowhere. Are you not seeing this?
100%. Like,
yeah, for sure. I mean, there's so many changes. We've got changes in the course, and speaking of the course, we caught up with Cordano Russell earlier for a course preview.
Yo, what's up, everybody? We're out here, World Skate Switzerland in Lausanne. And let's start with the course preview. We got this center area right here, this bump to ledge is super slippery on top. But hey, it's a fun obstacle. People are going in and up. We got some of the big rail action. This is a nice 9-stair rail. It's low to my quad. It's pretty good, it's fun. What is the hardest part about this rail though is that there's the hubba attached to the side right here. You were throwing a lot of people off, but if you stay focused only on the rail, you were all good. So next is this gap to rail right in the middle. It's great. People are gapping to it. Fun rail. Great obstacle. We have this little bump to bump here. People are either doing some tricks here, tray flips, kick flips, everything. Bump to bar. Nice long. Compared to my wingspan, it's definitely about 8 feet long for sure. Back on this side, right here, we have this perfect down hubba. This thing is awesome. It's buttery. It's nice. On both sides, you have these perfect little down square rails. Super great, super low. Let's do like the little height check. Up to the kneecap, pretty low. Super fun. And then back, here's a mirror of the big section. Bump the hubba. This guy right here, I love this thing. That's it, the rain's starting to come down. This is an amazing event, super blessed to be here. Later, guys.
So really good to hear there from Cordano, and he's got some serious pop, right?
His height differences make no sense to us. He's like 6'4".
And I'd want to spend some time and see what you think about the progression of women's skateboarding at the moment, Eric.
Oh, it's been a beautiful thing to watch, you know, just how many and how well it's growing. The skill level is technical, it's big, it's rails, it's really gnarly, and it's so impressive. It's so cool to see because it's good to see this evolution and more women getting into it, and it's awesome.
Yeah, back in the day, you might have just had Elisa around or something like that. I mean, but now there's more and more, and you can actually run a women's competition, right?
Yeah, exactly. You know, and Elisa's still around. She's a great homie. It was only a few of us. There's a few of them, a couple up there in the judges' booth, too, that were really just pioneers and really pushing pushing skateboarding, being a woman, where they were definitely they were outnumbered.
Yeah, for sure.
They worked hard. They killed themselves just as hard as any other skateboarder. And you've seen it out here now. And now it's more and more. And it's great that early pioneers to help push this new wave and the constant growth of skateboarding.
I mean, speaking about that new wave, we're now accruing points towards the Olympics. Mm-hmm. Did you think that would be a thing 20 years ago?
No, I definitely did not think that would be a thing 20 years ago. Had that been a thing 20 years ago, that would have been awesome.
You'd have done all right.
Well, I'd have tried my best, but it would have been so cool to just be at one, I would just love to experience that.
And I want to ask you, Eric, about strategy. I mean, we're like four phases of competition, qualifying, quarterfinals, semifinals, into the finals. Do you change anything up? Do you save something for the finals? What's the strategy there?
I think you do, to some degree, you kind of got to pace yourself a little bit, and you also kind of probably got to pay attention to what the field is doing, and maybe sometimes you don't want it because this score will come up and someone will do something gnarly and you just watch that and you're like, oh no, I have to do this to beat that, and the mind game is nuts. But yes, obviously there's got to be some strategy to this, and you got to know what you're doing. Yes. Out here, it's not just go out there and try whatever
free
you flowing. Want.
Yeah,
you
know, for it, sure.
You do have it, it's an analytical game.
The game doesn't change
just as much as it's physical. But
awesome. Well, thank you very much for spending some time for us, and really appreciate you being here. Really nice to meet you. And it's now time for us to get into the recap from our women's semi-finals.
Current world champion Ayesha Leal and Rome podium winner Yumeka Oda slipped into semi-finals by the slimmest of margins. Both look like themselves again and managed to qualify in both first and second place. The amount of pressure skaters have to deal with became obvious when every single skater in Heat 1 bailed their second runs. A few new faces at this stage of the competition, like Liv Lovelace and Lucy Schoonheer, gained some experience and valuable points. With a switch 50-50 in a run and a switch frontside board slide and a switch backside feeble attempt, Paige Hayne put the motherland of skateboarding on the map again in the women's field. In Heat 2, the insanely consistent duo of Funa Nakayama and Momiji Nishiya showed why they are bronze and gold medalists of the last Olympics. The resurgent Pamela Rosa has barely missed a beat in this contest and made it through to finals. Add to that the Dutch favourite Rose Vetsloot in eighth by the skin of her teeth, by leaving her patchy luck behind and pulling a hill flip frontside ball slide out of nowhere. A trick that lifted Ayui Umera into finals in Rome. Here in Lausanne, it wasn't meant to be for the young Japanese.
So good to see what happened yesterday. It's quickly to forget just how gnarly that was, right?
Yeah, I mean, we've seen four levels of competition. It's gotten gnarlier each phase. The finals are going to go off.
And talking about gnarly, Rayssa Leal is absolutely dominating out there, coming in a little bit low in the pack, but stepping it up at the final hour.
As always.
And we were lucky enough to catch up with Rayssa Leal earlier to find out about her time here.
So it's my first time here. I'm too excited. The park is really, really, really fun. Like the little bump to ledge and the big rail, the big sash. I think that makes like the competition fun and good. It's not like just Brazilian. It's like Peru, Chile, Mexico. So it's like all the countries we don't see like usually in like Sri League or X Games. So that makes it special. The Japanese girls is a little different, like the tricks and like the style too. They love like to skate, to learn new tricks, not like the same tricks we usually see. Like they are too good. We are a big, big family. All the boys and girls always supporting each other, so it's good.
So, Chris, at this point in the competition, what's the strategy?
I think, you know, Eric touched on it, but the strategy is to build on your difficulty. I asked him about that, you know, exact thing. And you want to save something in the finals that you didn't do in the semifinals or qualifying and surprise the judges and the fans and the crowd.
Yeah, for sure. But it's not just about getting on the podium here. I mean, that is important, but it's about accruing those points because we're on the road to Paris 2024. And their points go from around 31st. You're going to get points on the board, but it's all about that top 10. So top 10 are going to get scored really well. 10th place is going to get 10,258 points. And first place is going to get 50,000 points. So it's all on the line still.
100%. And we saw some people get injured and just force themselves onto the course to do a couple board slides just to get some points on the board.
But the interesting story is over 50% of our current world scoring ranking is Japanese.
Yes.
Six Japanese skaters in the top 10. That's crazy.
Yeah, and men and women's, they're just dominating streets. So it's unbelievable. It's great to see.
But with only three places available per country to get through to the Olympics, that field is going to need to be cut in half. And it's going to be an interesting story because there's been some injuries and people not attending this competition.
Yeah.
And that's opened the door for other people to start climbing that ladder and get into that top three going to the Olympics.
Yeah, I mean, you can feel the tension in the air. You know, skateboarding competitions used to be all about fun and family. But there's a seriousness to this. There's so much on the line.
Yeah, and it's going to be gnarly for some of those skaters because they're going to be knocking, you know, potentially three other people out of the way, and they're not going to attend the Olympics, but they obviously want to represent their country.
Yeah, it's friendly fire, but it's definitely fire.
So, Chris, let's take a look at our format for today.
Yeah, I really like the format this year. It's a 2-5-3 format. So you get two 45-second runs, five best trick attempts, and three counting scores. One of your run scores has to count. So flow and consistency really comes into play.
Yeah, it's a great format, but translating that into scores isn't easy. And the third member of our team, Samantha Bruce, caught up with Judge Corey Duffel earlier.
thank you so much for joining me here, Corey. You're one of the judges in the booth, which is a very difficult job to do. We're going to talk about consistency and judging fairly. Obviously, we're at different skate parks all the time. The courses slightly vary, and obviously, we've got skaters who are moving up and down and coming in and out. How do you deal with that? How do you keep it consistent and fair?
There's five of us up there, and so we're lucky to have all eyes on the course, and nobody's missing anything. Where we study constantly, we're watching videos before time, we're watching all our notes that we take, and every day we're up there prepping for like 12 hours, it seems. It's nonstop, so that's how we stay consistent. Just sharp, skate nerds, we love it, you know?
Well, there you have it, a first from a judge in the booth. Coming up next, we have got the finals, so make sure that you stick around, don't go anywhere, because it's about to light up.
Right then, Chris, let's take a look at our start list for today. Rose Zwetsloot in there, Pamela Rosa, Yumika Oda, who was smashing it and having the privilege of skating last. We have Brazilian Rayssa Leal. But definitely don't sleep on Momiji Nyjah either. Been really, really smashing it in practice, right?
Yeah, Momiji is so, so consistent.
So, looks like we are good to get this women's final underway. And we'll be kicking it off with Rose Zwetsloot from the Netherlands. So, each rider gets two 45-second runs and five best tricks. And this is run one of two for Rose. Starting off with that lip slide, Chris.
Ah, no. Stepping off a 5-0 grind. That's a rare miss for Rose.
Yeah, but first run nerves.
First one jitters.
That is definitely a thing.
Yeah, and so our viewers understand there's two runs, 45 seconds. One of those run counts has to carry over. So you need a good run beyond the best trick.
So getting back in the mix, looking to clear that driveway, just missing the 50-50. Looked like that fall got into her head a bit there, Chris.
Those were some basics for Rose. I think she's going to put it together. Run number two, the crowd's behind her, European favorite.
But we saw it yesterday, Rose really shined in the best trick section, right?
Yeah. I believe she did a heel flip front board, if I'm not mistaken, which was insane.
Getting the knucks there from coach. And I mean, we mentioned it before, it's strange to us that this coach is now in skateboarding, but it's very much a thing that, you know, they're taking advice on the fly, and it's maybe an outside look into what the competition's running like, because when you're skating, you don't know what's going on.
It's a difficult wire to walk, because it's a sport now, but skateboarding is an art. You got to combine those two elements.
Okay, taking it over to Brazil with the powerhouse, Pamela Rosa. Starting things off. Oh, okay. You said it before, Chris. falls can be contagious.
That's just such a rare miss for Pamela. You see in competitions, if the first run is perfect, you often see like four more perfect runs. If the first run is a bail, it can get contagious and get inside the other skaters' heads a little bit.
But I think Pamela showing the knowledge about skating competitions there and scratching that run off and not wasting any of the energy. And just saying, you know what, I'm going to call it on that. Yeah. Not going to skate, and I'll...
She is a fierce competitor.
Yeah, and she can certainly turn it on when it's needed, for sure.
Yeah, she doesn't look fast.
So, 0.26 coming in there. The youngest one in the finals, 13 years of age. So that's two riders down in our run section. Next up, we are taking it to Japan with Koko Yoshizawa.
Yeah, this field dominated by Japan.
starting it off with that frontside 50-50, backside tail slide on the bump to rail. Looking good so far.
Yeah, she's looking solid. Bump to back 50 there.
And the thing is,
stepping off the kickflip.
I was just about to say, if you stood on the platform, you're like, okay, I've seen two failed runs, like two falls within that, but that doesn't mean I'm going to. But you then start doubting yourself, right?
Yeah.
And the more confident skaters, although, you know, Rose is very confident, certainly Pamela as well.
You know, skaters often feed off each other's energy.
Oh, there's a great recovery there with a gap over to backside lip slide.
Yeah, got to mention, only 13 years old. There's that perfect kickflip.
So, at this point, a few practice runs maybe, Chris. Just using that time to get your head back in the game. And we do see it. We saw it yesterday. A bit of first run nerves coming through.
Yeah, 100%. There's been a lot of stops and starts with practice. So, people are just getting their footing.
So 52.52, and obviously jumping into that first place position as we move forward. You can see a bit disappointed there, but that's why we've got two runs, but it does then put the pressure on.
Yes.
So talk about consistency, and someone who shines in this section as well is Momiji Nyjah.
Yeah, she is our gold medalist from the Olympics in Tokyo, and you're going to see why.
That comfortable style, just this is a walk in the park.
Oh, look at that. Oh, we've seen her make that every single time in practice.
Yeah, we were rehearsing earlier, and I turned around, and every time I turned around, she landed that trick.
Nice salad grind. Props to Eric Dressen. That was a trick he invented in the 80s.
Nice. Speed grind, popping that out early to land on the bank as high as possible to keep that speed. Coming down to the last 5 seconds. And I mean, that's worth saying, Chris, it comes down to timing as well.
Yeah, getting that backside lip slide in there. All right. That was a nice recovery. That's part of the game as well. If you have a fall, you can't get shook up. You got to just recover.
You got to just go, that didn't happen. I'm still chilling. It's all good, but it's very
like
hard to.
Cordano mentioned, it's like you have to have the memory of a goldfish.
Yeah, for sure. So, waiting for Momiji's first run score to come through. Just missing the crooked grind, nollie heel flip out. 62.22.
Hey, best score so say. So today, so far, so not too shabby.
So next skater up, also from Japan, we've got Funa Nakayama. Dropping up onto the big section to kick it off with the rail.
Nice.
What we were saying yesterday, a lot of the more educated skaters are saying, if I get two hits on the big rail, that's putting my score way higher, right?
Yeah, 100%. That nine-stair obstacle has been a maker or breaker. So far, so good from Funa.
Coming down to 20 seconds remaining on run number one. Hitting up the rail for the second time.
Frontside crooked. Yeah,
Funa
that was
struggling
great.
With that yesterday, and it looks like she's just gone and worked on that in practice. And, you know, putting it in the run section is a big deal.
Yeah. One more trick in here. Let's see what we got. She got missed a feeble, but hung on. Okay, so it's not an actual fall. So I dare to say that's the best run we've seen yet.
Yeah, and I think some similar issues from semifinals yesterday for Funa. She missed the feeble in that run as well. But this is where we kicked it off with that styly backside lip slide.
Nice frontside board slide, looking over that shoulder. And there's that frontside crooked grind. I would say that was the highlight of that run.
Yeah, like I say, to go back to that after struggling with it yesterday, that's guts and confidence.
A waiting score. The tensions are running a little high.
62.23 is what is needed to take the lead. Definitely getting that.
There we go.
68.62. Okay. Looks like she's happy with it.
That's a great first run score. It's going to give her some added confidence.
Out of the US, we have Paige Hayne dropping in for run number one and kicking it off with that backside 50-50.
Yeah, Paige is our only USA skater in the women's field, which is pretty mind-blowing because competitions, you know, 10, 15 years ago were dominated by the USA, and it's now a global event, a global series, and it's stacked. Brazil representing Japan. Nice, switch 50-50. We saw that yesterday. That got her quite a bit of points.
Well, that's the thing that separates Paige from the rest of the pack is she's throwing in those switch tricks. Hopefully we're going to see
the judges
now.
Really like that. Yeah, the judges really scored that well.
Caballero also switching it up, but maybe saving a little bit of something to sprinkle onto run number two. Great run there for Paige, though.
Yeah, no falls. Getting some props from USA coach John Nicholson. Properly so. So here we go. Perfectly locked Smith grind.
And we were chatting with Cordano yesterday on the broadcast about how important it is to do something that feels really good as your first trick, and that kind of builds you up for the rest of the run.
Yeah, you want to start with a bang, but you don't want to screw yourself up by falling.
So that switch 50-50 is going to be a high-scoring trick. And hitting the handrail as well. The backside 50-50 along the long rail.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
That's a great score. 64.89 coming through. As we take it round and back to Japan. Yumika Oda, run number one. Straight into that long rail. Yeah.
Nice.
There's that front blunt. So good on that and really consistent. Chris.
Yeah. Speed all the way through. Solid kickflip there. Yumika looks like she's on fire at the moment.
Yeah, coming into that big section and the handrail going to the front feeble. I would be very interested to see if seeing the front side crooked grind go down mid-run, whether she's just changed it up and said, oh, you know what, I'm going to have to put the front feeble in.
Yeah, that could be.
But then again, knowing Yumika, she's got that trick so dialed. Time for one last one, doubtful.
Yeah, so we're seeing quite a few falls, which hopefully changes for run number two and puts added pressure on the best trick section.
Yeah, it really does. We saw it yesterday, if you're below maybe 60, you're going to struggle during the best trick section because that's when the leaderboard starts shuffling around a lot.
Yeah, and we saw some people completely recover in best trick alone.
Yeah, Rose was a prime example of that. Scraping through and getting in there. Really stoked she did, though. Big fan of Rose's skating. So 37.20. Bit of work to do for run number two. So our final rider before we take it back to the top of the heat. Out of Brazil, we have Rayssa Leal. Kicking it off in the big section where she's very comfortable showing that there with
back
a stylish backflip.
You know, I gotta say, Rayssa just has like an added confidence. Just the speed, the consistency. You know what I mean?
Yeah,
like,
and I think
it just looks like she's already on to the next trick.
Yeah,
she's landing something. Whoa, a little rare sketch there.
She's landed a trick before she's even tried it.
Yes, like that gap to lip slide right there. There was no question in her mind she was going to land that.
Whoa, changing it up. And we're seeing new things today, like Eric was saying earlier. We're seeing new tricks that we didn't see before.
But the solid repetition nose grind. Okay, that was 100% the best run we've seen so far. No doubt.
Yeah, for sure. For sure. And it's worth saying that the repetition rule is there. And if people are repeating tricks on the day, you will get docked. But it's all a brand new day today. Anything that was done yesterday is not going to affect your score.
And you want to hang on to some surprise tricks for the best trick section. You don't want to show all your cards immediately.
We saw that backside lip slide. Look at that. Fully locked and popped.
We see that style, that added bit of confidence.
Well, you know, we've got an esteemed panel of judges up there in the booth. You know, Vanessa Torres, Garrett Hill is the head judge.
Corey
JB
Duffel.
Gillet, Corey Duffel. Yeah. You know, we've got some big, big names up there, and they know about style. They know about execution. They know what's good and what's not. You know, they know that that's a pretty gnarly nine-stair rail, and they're rewarding those tricks.
With a hubba, like, half a foot underneath it, which is... definitely can get in your head.
Yeah, 74.56 coming through for Rayssa as we move on to run number two for Rose. Starting off with that front side lip slide. The pressure is on, but I think Rose is going to be able to really relax more now.
There's that 5-0. You know, that's a walk in the park for her. Yeah, nice front blunt slide.
Way more comfortable. Rolling back into... get that speed up for the gap.
Lots of speed. Gapping out to 50.
Leaning back a little bit on that. Nearly into a 5-0.
Yeah, she almost
it
premoted
done.
A bit. She recovered it well.
Up to crooked grind. This is shaping up to be a great run. Still time for one last hit.
Okay, front board.
Just clipping it. And you saw there was a bit of a power slide as she carved across on that. And I had a little skate around on the course earlier. And... yeah, some of the wooden bits are a little bit slippery, but we've had a little downpour of rain earlier. It delayed things slightly, but maybe there's a bit too much moisture in the air, and it is really making some of the ramps slippery.
Yeah, and we've seen people struggle with the nine stair a bit because it's pretty steep. Kind of shoots you right into the ground, so you have to land perfectly.
Yeah, but a big shout out to California Skate Parks for building a great course. They had 4 days to build this course
on top
of a fountain. And then they got 2 days to take it down starting tomorrow. So 59.17 coming in for Rose, run number two. Definitely a nice place to be moving forward. And looking to drastically improve on run number one is Pamela Rosa.
There it is. Gap lip slide. All right, she's another one that just looks ultra confident on her board. Nice 5-0.
I like to see
that hustle.
Pamela and speed are definitely very good friends. Gap to frontside Smith grind.
Yeah, we talked about that trick. It's relatively basic, but it can jump over to a lip slide accidentally so easily. And then we see a big spin front board to fakie. That's going to add some serious points.
Gap crooks, lipping out. We saw that yesterday. The crook didn't quite get down. And when I was walking the course, that's one thing that stood out. Going off of that kicker onto the downside of that hubba is no joke. That is a very, very steep and high landing. But definitely an improvement on run number one.
Yeah, that nine stair, the whole section... that's the feature of the contest, but it's definitely challenging.
55.21. We were saying it. You don't really want to be much lower than that, do you, as you go through to
the trick section? That's a cutoff, and it puts a lot of pressure on her best trick attempts.
So we're taking it back round to Coco Yoshizawa. Run two of two. Starting off with the frontside 50-50 and the backside tail slide.
Yeah, smooth start so far. Gap 50, or bump to 50, excuse me. Nice
kickflip. Same run that we've seen before, but an improvement already, having missed that kickflip last run.
Big spin front board. It's crazy that's a common trick these days.
Yeah, shout out to Eric Ellington bringing that one.
Yeah.
So coming down to the last few seconds with a gap backside lip slide. Every go, backside ollie.
We saw a bunch of gap frontside lip slides. I like that she added the backside lip slide. That's going to be a great run score, I believe.
What's good about that run at the end there, Chris, is we've seen it before in qualifiers and in semifinals. Someone finished their run early, and they were like, oh, I'm just going to sneak a trick in.
Yeah.
But the bails are scored. So,
true.
If you bail, your overall score is going to go down because you have a missed trick within it.
And there we see that big spin front board. gapping out backside lip slide, I think that was a really, really smart trick because we've seen a ton of the gap frontside board lip slides.
So 57.70.
Okay.
Yep. Jumping way up there. Judges rewarding that run. And I think the backside lip slide helped with that. So much style and slid it really, really long and well. Talking about style, we're taking it back to Momiji Nyjah.
Yeah, Momiji's one of our favorites, one of the crowd favorites as well. Gap lip slide.
Even that front side ollie is just chill. So good. Are we going to see it this time?
There it is.
To go back to that, having failed it, it would be easy to just go, oh, you know what? I'm going to do the crook.
Yeah, salad grind. There we go.
So good.
All right, she's got to stay on here. Let's see what she's got. Front side Smith.
That kick flip.
I see a little smile out of her.
Hustling over. 5 seconds on the clock, and this is going to be really well timed. Backside lip slide. And she's happy with that. That was a flawless run there.
That's going to give Rayssa a little run for her money right there.
Yeah.
Great run.
Nolly heel halfway through that as well, Chris. That's something special. And that's what we're talking about, that progression of women's skateboarding exponentially. Mm. It's so good. And we're watching it in real time right here in Lausanne, Switzerland.
Yes. I back that.
Here it is. Crook. Nolly heel.
Just the foot placement there.
Yeah. Check out this back foot straight into position and then catching the tail there. And that's what brings the spin round.
I love how she doesn't, like, awkwardly place her feet for any of those tricks. You know what I mean? Like, she's got a regular, like, a kind of consistent stance.
Yeah. Really solid style. 88.91.
There we go.
Wow, that's what it takes. And do you know what? That's because of the flip out. That is. You
100%.
Know, everything else was amazing, but when you're taking that risk of the board leaving your feet, that is very high risk, but very high reward.
I would dare to say it's the most difficult trick we've seen so far.
For sure. So staying with Japan, and we're back to Funa Nakayama. Currently in that third place position. There's the backside lip slide. Followed up with just missing the heel flip.
Yeah. But she's sitting on a 68.62. So she's doing all right so far, even with this fall.
And that's what's good about getting that first run out of the way. It opens up your, you know, freedom to try some other things and maybe, you know, just have an exploration of other tricks that you might want to do.
Yeah. You can basically take a practice run. We often see people warm up for their best trick attempts when they have a veiled run.
Onto that frontside 50-50 on the long ledge.
That's going to be after time, unfortunately.
You can see disappointment there, but 68.62 to take through to the best trick section.
I want to say that's a solid score.
Yeah.
But puts pressure on the best trick section for sure.
34.03, so sticking with that first run score as we take it back to the USA and Paige Haynes.
Yeah, it's such an honor to even make it to a finals with this level of competition.
Well, we saw it yesterday in semifinals. People are stepping it up just to get to this point.
Yeah.
You know, it was like a final yesterday. I know a lot of people say that, but it really was. And Jake Ilardi was saying it's a proper battle just to get to semifinals, let alone be in the finals. And with cutting the field in half, taking only 8 from 16 through, it is gnarly. So everyone threw everything they had at it.
Nice switch 50-50. Yeah, there's no room for what we used to call a safety run, where you just kind of go through the motions.
Sneaking in the ollie blunt there on the buzzer.
All right, we got the sun popping out here.
Yeah, it's been a bit of a mixed day. It's warm, it cools down, and then it rains. Then it goes straight back to being hot again. But yeah, Sun back out. Great run there, 53.50. So sticking with that first run score of the 64.89. So back to Japan and Yumika Oda. Currently got that 37.20, so definitely work to do there. Starting
nice.
Off that front side, blunt slide. That's a long, long rail, Chris.
Yeah, takes some serious balance to hang on to that. Nice kickflip, good pop there.
Turn it round up on that big section. Going towards the rail. There's the front side feeble. Needed to get that done this time. I haven't seen what's just happened.
With that hubba underneath it and those vertical slats, the front feeble is a really scary trick to try on that obstacle.
100%. So, gearing up for that one last trick. Coming in for the bump to hubba.
Nice.
Interested to see on that there. She just did a little nolly out of the bank and went up and went, I need to get this done. I need to compose myself. And sometimes it's worth maybe skipping a trick to try and get that ending because, you know, you were saying it before. You want to start on a banger and finish on a banger.
Yeah. That's Mike Valley, skateboarding legend, a good friend of mine, always said that. Start with a bang, end with a bang. Start with something to wow everybody, and then you gotta end with something. Especially with the judges, it's fresh on their mind when you do something amazing with your last trick. It makes a difference.
So this is where we kicked it off. Big front side, blunt slide, taking that truck all the way over the rail and sliding on the tail.
Yeah, you called it. That's a tough one to hang on for that long.
And then you see that great kickflip there. And as we said before, as soon as the board leaves your feet, it's a high-risk maneuver.
There's that bump to crooked grind.
Eagerly waiting that score, 66.41. She's happy with that.
She's happy with that.
Yeah. Really happy to take that through to best trick section. And we have one last rider before we take it through to that section. Currently in second place, we have Brazilian Rayssa Leal. 74.56. Let's see how she's going to step things up. Kicking it off with that crooked grind, bumping in. Do you see her arms barely move then, Chris?
Oh, she missed that kickflip. Right, that is such a rare fall for Rayssa. But she's a competitor. She can recover quick. Look at that.
I mean, look at that. Okay, missed the kickflip, but I'll just kickflip into a trick instead.
Yeah.
Back to the rail, backside Smith grind.
Dips.
Yeah, proper locked.
Yeah, I think that's, these days it seems to be the game plan. If you fall, you've got to step it up and make your run even more difficult than you planned.
Yeah, up to backside 5-0. Time for one last one if she's quick.
Ah.
That one's going to be after time,
oh,
I believe.
I wish that was in time.
That was the front side blunt slide. But do you know what? I think having seen what's happened and what scores are coming through for people who are falling on their runs, I think she was like, I'm not going to beat the 74, so I might as well just, you know, have a roll around, put on a bit of a show and maybe practice some
tricks. She went straight into that kickflip board. There we see it. That was after the fall. So much style, confidence there.
Yeah, a lot of skateboarding is confidence though, Chris, isn't it? You know,
if you
doubt yourself, you're kind of going to fall off. But if you're like, I've got this, it kind of works for you, doesn't it?
Yeah, yeah. It's a mental game as much as it is a physical game.
Okay, heavy score with a full 64.03. That just tells you how gnarly those tricks were.
Yeah. And that's 74.56. I think that's pretty good in terms of where she's sitting moving into best trick.
Yeah, and that is the first section of our women's street competition finals over and done with, and it's time to take it to the third member of our team, Samantha Bruce, who is with Rayssa's coach.
Hi, Fernando. Thank you so much for being here with me. So you've currently got two Brazilians in the finals, both Aissa and Pamela, which is incredible. But at the moment, Aissa is in the lead. We saw earlier on, not many people know this, but she was injured in practice. What's her mentality like going into finals?
Yeah, she just like hit her knee during the practice. So She did a little bit of recovery, physiotherapy, and she's good. She's fine. Pamela is good. So we're super stoked and hyped, and the expectation is super high. Let's see what's up.
I mean, she looked incredible in run number one. It was a perfect run. She had a bit of a wobble, but she managed to recover. And then on the second run, she didn't complete it, but she's still sitting pretty high. Do you think perhaps for best trick, she might try to step it up? We saw that in Rome, she didn't quite make the kick flip back tail, but do you think she might try it again?
I'm not sure. Like, she's super natural. She has like a lot of tricks. And let's see how she will like decide what she's gonna play the game.
Perfect. Thank you so much for that. And it's back to Mark and Chris in the studio.
Thank you very much, Sam. Good to hear from coach there. And yeah, Rayssa had a bit of a fall in practice, but seems to have recovered from that pretty well.
Yeah, and quickly talk strategy moving into best trick. I think you want to do something that you didn't do in your run section.
Yeah, and here we have our top three, third place. Taking that frontside tail slide. There's the frontside crooked grind. Trademark trick there for Funa.
Yeah, and
50.
Two of our top three competitors are Japanese. So they're dominating the field currently.
Yeah, for sure. And second place before we go to best trick, we got Rayssa Leal, front blunt. You know, she came straight out where other people had fallen, just put on, you know, okay, cool, you're not going to get in my head, I'm on it. And first place at the moment, we have Momiji Nyjah. Look at that, crooked grind, nolly heel flip out mid-run, and then came back with that salad grind.
That was the trick of the run, for sure.
Wasn't it? Came through with the frontside Smith grind as well. So that is our run section over and done with. Each skater has had two 45 second runs on the course, and now we head over to the trick section. So each skater gets 5 attempts at any trick anywhere on the course. You're probably going to see a lot of those tricks go down on the big rails. That's where the big money's at and where the highest scores are coming from. But you can use any part of the course, and we're kicking it off with trick number one for Rose Zwetslum.
Nice, yes, front feeble.
That's a good way to start.
That was smart. She needs some points.
Yeah, but obviously, as we move through, years ago, you'd do a trick and be like, oh, yeah, I got through to the final because I maybe did those tricks. Now, they're writing down every trick score, and they're like, okay, so a front feeble's getting in the region of this.
Oh,
so
yeah.
They'll then study that and say, right, if I do that, I'm going to get this kind of score. That's where I want to start my journey
100%.
With. 81.69, great score there, and 140.86. But like we say, you have to take one of your run scores as your overall score, and then two of your trick scores.
Wow.
Pamela Rosa just sketching out off the backside Smith grind.
With the steepness of that rail, you really, like I mentioned, you have to land perfectly.
So we're taking it straight on to
Yoshizawa. You know, I like this format. You know, 5 attempts, only 2 of them are going to count. So it allows you room to just be risky and throw something out there.
Oh, look at that. Yes. I've got your back, Pamela, she said there. Straight into the backside Smith grind. Made it look way, way easy. And you know what? A lot of these Japanese skaters, like we said in the open of the show, there's 3 spots available to go through to the Olympics. But there's 6 Japanese in the top 10. So that has to be cut in half.
Yeah.
And each and every one of them is trying to get as many points as possible.
Yeah.
And with an injury in there, you know, some of the skaters aren't actually here. So it's that door's wide open to walk through.
And half the competitors in this final are Japanese.
Wow. Well, going for the Suski grind. You don't see them often. There's a reason for that.
Yeah.
That can easily slip out.
Momiji is so consistent. I expect a quick recovery.
Oh, she's definitely got 2 bangers for this. And with 4 more attempts, it's not looking bad so far as we take it on to Funa Nakayama. Be interested to see where Funa goes, because she's got a huge trick bag. Already put the front crook down in the run, though, and that was one of her best tricks yesterday, right?
Yeah. We'll see. I mean, like I said, I think the element of surprise factors in. Nice. Wow. Backside over crooks. We didn't see that in the run section, so that was, I think that was a really smart trick.
Yeah, I think that's probably going to be a huge score there.
Yeah. First time we've seen that trick today.
So popping all the way over. In that toe, yeah, holding it all the way to the end. So waiting for that score to come through. Trick attempt one, 88.88. Hell of a score there, Chris.
Amazing. So that was our highest point score of the day so far.
Yeah, so far, as we take it on to trick attempt one of 5-4 page nine. Well, going for the front feeble, but you know what? Getting away, you can see that little smirk going, oh, you know what?
Oh, there she goes at the cross. That's so, not going to count.
It's perfect opportunity to talk about this. So the skater can choose, if they've tried a trick, to scratch it completely, and everybody's got to forget that they've tried it, and the repetition rule doesn't count, and they get to try it again.
Yes. So I really like that rule.
Yeah, so you're not going to get docked for potentially doing the same trick. So back round to Yumika Oda. Okay.
Another over crooks.
Yeah, okay. I got that backside nose grind as well.
You talked about that score and how skaters feed off each other. So she's likely seeing that. That scored big points so far.
Well, that's another
smart
thing
choice.
Is when you know you've got one of those tricks that you've seen someone else do already, you go, okay, they got this score for that. I've got that, and that's a great score. I'll do it as well. So playing it clever there.
We see popping all the way over. You got to almost get into a frontside crooked grind. Traveling over the rail. It's a very difficult trick.
Getting that pinch on the front foot, holding it all the way down through the rail. 88.11
nice.
Coming through. That sees Yumika up there with 154.52 points on the score already.
Great score.
So final rider before we go on to tricks number two, Brazilian Rayssa Leal. Kickflip front board.
Okay, well, hey, we talked about it. You got to switch it up. You got to surprise the judges. So I think that was a smart attempt. Nope. She's got four more attempts.
Okay, going to the top of the order, seven attempts.
I saw her do that trick perfectly earlier in practice, but I'm not sure if that was the one she slammed on. And that's the thing with skateboarding. Going back to something that hurt you is really difficult.
Yeah, that's a mind game. Rose going for that heel flip frontside board side. We saw that yesterday.
I think that's the trick that got her through to the finals.
100%.
Yeah, it was
she popped
first
it
go
so
as well.
Well.
So good. Yeah, caught it really high and just stamped her feet down on the rail. So, second trick of five for Pamela Rosa. Coming back into that big rail. There's the backside
back
Smith.
Yeah.
You saw there, so she hung her toe over a little bit more to hold on to that grind and make it a little bit more secure.
Yeah, that's with her trick bag, that's definitely strategic. She's like, I need to land something.
Looking so composed, I'd be losing my mind if I just backsmith the nine stair rail, Chris. I'd be running around like a lunatic. So 82.61 coming in there. 137.82.
That was a smart choice.
Yeah, and that's out of the way now. She can move on and go, okay, let's get in to the next gnarly tricks. So Koko Yoshizawa, trick two of five. Dropping in on that big section, getting that foot ready for the flip. Oh, go big spin.
Big spin front board. I believe that's the first time we've seen it done on the big rail.
Made it look so, so easy. And, you know, watch this replay. She was so comfortable and had landed it before she'd even dropped in, I think. It's a mind game that you play.
Yeah, I mean, the people that do that trick well, it's like they don't place their feet awkwardly. It just sort of comes together. You know, it's like it's not much pop really there, but it's just enough to get onto the rail. Got to land perfectly.
But like we heard before, you know, some people are saying the rail get-ons a little bit low. so you don't really want too much pop. But look at that score, Chris. 84.29 coming
through. Wow. Okay.
Awesome. That sees her now into that first place position. Yeah, 224.47 on the board already as we take it round to Momiji Nyjah from Japan. Trick attempt 2 of 5. There you go.
There's that Suski grind.
Yeah. So it's the tweaked backside 5-0. I mean, you're not really going to backside 5-0 that rail like straight. You're going to want to pinch it somehow.
Yeah.
You see a lot of people do it with their heel. But that one was tweaked over. But, Chris, I'm very glad to say that we've got a guest in the booth with us. Kate, good to see you.
Hello.
Thanks for joining us.
Thank you for having me.
Awesome. Good to have you in the booth again.
Yeah, we're back.
Yeah. How did you find the competition so far?
It was fun. I like the park. The vibes are good. Everybody's killing it. Watching this final, too, everybody's doing so good and so sick to see the level step up from the other rounds, too.
And we talked about the psychology of going from the run section to the best trick. Can you talk on that a bit?
I mean, you're going for more so your safe tricks that you can do, you know, back to back to the ones that are a little bit tougher and you don't want to put in that run. So it's a little bit more of a mind game.
Yeah, and I mean, we've seen a few skaters, like, if the first skater falls, it seems like the next few fall. If the first skater has an amazing, like, solid run, the other skaters do as well. Is that sort of happen? Is bailing a little contagious?
I guess you get the hype if someone gets the run. You know, you kind of want to, like, back it up. But, I mean, in the end, someone's got to break it through. If someone's failing, you don't keep failing. And in the end, someone's going to have to make the whole run.
So, dropping in for trick attempt 2 of 5, we have Paige Hine. There's that switch frontside board slide. See the fist bump then? Yes, got it done. First go again.
I think that score is in the 80s.
It should be a really high score. I think switch and you're going blind backwards.
She did it so comfortably, too. I mean, if you weren't mistaken, it just looked like a regular frontside board slide.
It might even be easier for her.
That's true.
For that score, 87.89.
Wow.
Huge score coming in.
Yeah, she needed a relatively big score.
How do you find this course differs from Rome?
The Rome course had, like, long, mellow rails, and these are, like, really steep ones that shoot you.
Oh, my God.
What?
Wow.
Where did that come from?
Frontside feeble?
Where it is.
I don't think I even saw that in the men's competition.
First go, and not just a kickflip frontside feeble. It's, like, the best one I think I've ever seen.
Could not have been
nice. Like, what?
She could not have been a better than she did.
That's got to break the 90.
Yeah, wow, that's got
that's
to.
Gonna be like 90.
Look at the rampage. So high. The biggest scream all day from the crowd as well. How important is it to get that crowd screaming? Do you feed off of that?
Yeah, for sure. I mean, if the crowd's hyped, you get the hype too.
So, Kate, we talked about this obstacle. You got the hubba right there. You've got the vertical slats. Mm-hmm. Is it sort of a mind game?
It is.
I mean, it shoots you right into the ground.
Yeah, and
what are the challenges of that obstacle?
The little poles are, like, a little thicker, so sometimes when you don't lock in quite well, you can feel them.
Yeah.
It's just
your wheel can lock up.
Yeah.
That's going to be a scary feeling, that.
And you see the ledge. You can see the ledge.
Wow. That is one of the highest scores we've seen the whole weekend.
I think that's the highest score we've seen of competition.
95. And your new leader. Wow.
Well, we talked about the element of surprise, and that's exactly what that was.
Yeah, I don't think the judges saw that coming. We certainly didn't.
I thought she was going to maybe flip front board first, but she just went straight to it. I wonder what she's going to do next.
Yeah, I mean, that's the other thing. It's like, when you do something like that, you're like, well, okay, I've just done my best trick first go, but
right?
Yumika's amazing. I'm sure she's got plenty more to come. And Rayssa and Leal back in. Having some problems with that kickflip frontside board slide. Clutching at the knee there. But we've seen this before. When she's hurt herself, she can come back from it, right?
She can, yeah. She's the one to do it. Let's see.
We've got half this field is from Japan. So talk quickly about the Japanese domination. How has that happened?
I don't know. They all came so quick. I think first it was just, like, three of them, and then now it's, like, 25 every contest.
Yeah, every year, or almost every contest, we see a new name, a new face, and they're all amazing.
I think yesterday in the semis, it was like seven Japanese, and the rest was like, I think, three Brazilians, and the rest was like,
yeah, coming off of my era, the USA dominated. Brazil was right behind us, but yeah. It is definitely Japan's game these days.
Well, the new generation coming through. We saw a 10-year-old absolutely smashing it on the course in qualifiers, right?
I liked her helmet. I liked her little,
spiky.
Bow on the helmet.
Back to the top of the heat. Rose coming in. Her mindset right now must be...
heel flip front board.
Oh, there it is! Wow! Now, is she going to scratch it?
Candy's scratching it.
Okay.
Is she going to scratch it? Surely.
I think she's
winning. Yeah, okay, there you go. There we go. How important is that rule to have that?
I think it's so great. Important. Otherwise, you have to just jump off whenever you can.
Yeah.
Because your mind says, like, stay on. But if you have your hands on the ground, it's going to dock the score so much.
Yeah.
And you want it to be a zero.
But going back and doing it again, repetition rule comes in then, and it's going to be docked even more. Or it's going to be docked more than what you would have got. So there's no point going back unless you scratch it.
Mm-hmm, definitely.
It's a trick attempt. 3 of 5 for Pamela Rosa. Big spin, front side board slide. That's the thing. When you land in that a little bit awkward, you're like, well, I've got nowhere to go but along for the ride. And to be able to run out of it, you're going to be stoked.
Yeah, it's like that rail, you roll up to it, and it's so steep. I think every trick, you just got to get that first try out the way. And I haven't seen her try it in practice, so this might have been that one.
Yeah, we've been talking about how that's a relatively basic trick these days, a big
flip
front board.
Isn't that crazy?
Mind-blowing.
Yeah, crazy. Absolutely crazy. Coco Yoshizawa up for trick attempt 3 of 5.
Ah, no slide shove it. I want to say that hub is a bit steep to try that.
I was thinking about it, and I was like, maybe that's not the hub to try it on.
Yeah, shoot you kind of straight into the ground. There's some wax on there, obviously.
Yeah, you got to handle it really quickly.
When we saw Gustavo yesterday flipping out of the end of the rail, that's still quite low, I'd say.
It's a little bit higher, but still, I think maybe too low.
Not much time there to get something done.
Yeah.
Momiji Nishiya currently in that third place position.
Oh, rare fall.
I mean, Momiji's got that trick down. You can see the confidence she has going into that. But
yeah, it's her trick.
Yeah.
I think she was one of the first people to do it, or one of the first girls.
Yeah, I believe I've seen her do that trick.
She did it at the Olympics. I think that got her the gold.
Front hurricane, excuse me.
Yeah, that's crazy too.
So far, everybody's staying with that big rail section. Mm-hmm. I would have thought we would have seen some people doing the gap out over the driveway to the down rail, but
I wonder which trick though. Like, which trick would they do it on? Because they're all going for, like, double tricks, flip in or something. And on that row, it would be so scary.
So Funa is pretty injured, but going to drop in anyway. You
wrong
can see the pain there. But as we keep saying, we've got 6 Japanese skaters in the top 10 of the world rankings at the moment, and only 3 skaters from each country can represent their country at the Olympics. So everybody's trying to get maximum amount of points. And, you know, when you've not got many scores on the board, you know you need to take 2 scores through in this section. You know, you're going to have to drop in just to get it done.
Yeah, no, for sure. I feel like that's an even way harder pedal for them to get into the Olympics than anybody else.
So it looks like she's actually going to skip that run and take a 0 score and maybe compose herself. It's tough to come back from an injury and to drop in. It's a mind game as well, right?
Yeah, definitely. It's super tough, especially if it's down these big things.
Drop it and switch.
Wow, I was going to call it.
Wow.
I was going to call it earlier. I'd love to see the switch 50 down the rail.
She's got them so good.
I have not seen her do that trick yet on the big rail.
I've not seen anyone do that trick yet on the big rail.
No, what?
Like, male or female. Like, approaching that, going, I'm just about to switch 50-50 to 9-stair rail. That's gnarly.
Anything on that rail is scary. Switch 50 is something.
So, current leader. Oh, there we go.
Some different obstacle.
Yeah.
I like it.
Crooked grind, nollie flip out attempt. That would be a big, big score, I believe.
You think that will overdo the 88?
I Possibly. It's a long rail, that thing, and it's quite high to get onto.
It's a difficult trick. Nobody's doing it.
Yeah, for sure.
Rayssa with two zeros on the board. So rare for her.
Yeah, after this, the pressure could be on. Needs to get a make here. Otherwise, just be relying on two makes for the final two attempts. So, could be a pivotal moment right now for Rayssa.
Yeah, we thumbs you know, up. As it sees on the screen, we say Rayssa, but it's actually Rayssa, correctly pronounced in Brazil.
So trick attempt 3 of 5. Wow, there you go. And this is what she's known for, being able to just switch everything off. You could hear everybody went silent then. And just coming back from a trick that you've been struggling with, to just get it done like that shows good confidence and a good mental game, I'd say.
Yeah, yeah. How hard is that, Kate, to go back to the same trick you failed?
Oh, I hate it. You have to just keep going, and then you're like, wait, if I do it one more time, I kind of have to go to another trick, but I want to land this, and it's the redemption.
We talked about the mindset of a skater, and often you have to go back to the trick you bailed.
Yeah.
And if you're not careful, you can get fixated, and it can totally throw you off.
Sometimes you just got to do something else and then come back to it to just get your mind off of it.
And quickly, score to come through.
I was talking about this earlier.
That's a good one.
Really quickly, Kate. So, in a run, when you have a fall, how difficult is it to move forward and
scratch it and
have the rest of your run being amazing?
It just messes up all of the flow that you've got going on. Because I think in a run, you need to feed off the other tricks to get the next ones in.
The momentum. Yeah. Okay.
So
thank you for that.
Back in.
Wow.
Oh, no way. So, the pressure is now really on that fifth and final attempt, but she came through with all the power in the final hour yesterday.
I know, it was the perfect one yesterday.
Yeah.
One more time.
We believe in you, Rose.
Yeah, sometimes, like we keep mentioning the element of surprise, sometimes landing that trick you bailed gets the judges even more hyped.
Sometimes, yeah. I think that definitely helps, you know, when they see you struggle a little bit on it and you finally get it.
So Pamela Rayssa back in for trick 4 and 5.
There it is.
Oh, wow.
Both of them just got so perfectly into the front board and then rolled.
Yeah, so just not getting the full rotation.
It's just because the rail is so steep. It's just in the end, you have to be off already. Well, you think you have more time, I guess.
Yeah, you have to mentally. It looks like you have to mentally turn off about 2 feet before the end.
With those tricks, it's like get in, get out. You can't wait for it to get out itself, I guess.
Pamela's now in that same situation as Rose, with that last trick attempt having to be landed to be in with a chance to get on that podium.
You know, if I was her coach, I would just say that's the wrong trick for that obstacle.
I mean, this one was pretty close, and I guess I don't know what else she would be doing.
Yeah, I mean, there's no such thing as a wrong trick, but
no.
I just think it's
but that
it's
obstacle is definitely
too
difficult for it.
Yeah, shoot you two into the ground to have time for that big spin.
And it's so short, like the rail, it's just like you get on and you have to get off right away.
There it is.
Oh, no. That trick is really, really
everybody's
taking a lot of people
everyone
out.
It's putting some pressure on herself. Wow. All she needed was I was hoping she landed it and go for the big spin flip front board.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, maybe that's the thing. It's almost like you've got to start unlocking a trick. You do one version of it first and go, right, okay, I'm moving on to the harder version.
Yeah.
But maybe the last attempt's going
to
be
I know. Now you have to see if she wants to get in that top, like, top position. Yeah. Maybe she has to do it, flip in.
Yeah, I mean, a lot of times skaters are just stoked to make it to the final, and you're like, everything's good. But with the Japanese skaters, there's a lot of pressure on the line.
Yeah.
So Funa Nakayama in.
Just getting that
for the board
score.
Slide. Injured her wrist and just getting another score on the board. Playing it safe. Knowing that those points are so, so important.
Yeah, we saw from Jay Gilardi, he got super injured and just took his second run, just willed himself to get some points.
Like she won't be taking her last attempt, and the crowd really showing their appreciation as she leaves the course. Goes straight to our medical team. We've got a great medical team out here, best in the business, and they'll be looking after her.
Yeah.
22.87 coming through. But that sees her in third place right now.
Yeah, she's, I mean, the third person that has two scores on the board. All the rest isn't happening.
So looking to get that next score on the board. Trick 4 of 5.
Going back
Page.
To it. The switch 50. There
oh,
it is.
There it is.
Yes.
Wow. You see that?
Wow.
Yes, then. Oh, so hyped. That was incredible.
Wow. I think she surprised herself.
No one else is doing that.
Yeah.
No
That's
one.
Insane.
I didn't see her try that in practice or any of the qualifying rounds.
She's got that trick down.
Yeah, get prepared for a heavy score to come through.
That was insane.
For trick 4
so
of 5.
So perfect.
Now that gives her another chance to wipe out that 87.89, which is crazy, right? To be talking about dropping a score.
Wow, look at that.
91.
Yes. Wow.
Huge score. Jumps her up into second place.
Yeah, 243.92. Very respectable score on the board. And we're taking it back round to Japan with Yumika Oda. We saw that 95.25. Where do you go from there?
Oh,
go for the crook nolly flip. That's what you do.
Yeah, well, hey, we saw someone move away from the nine stair.
I want her to get that. So sick.
Yeah, I'd really like to see that. I think the crowd would explode.
Yes. There's a lot of people here today.
Yeah, it was absolutely rammed yesterday, but I don't think there's a spare seat anywhere in the stands.
No,
today.
I was like just behind Olu's people and like the balcony over there, and I couldn't see anything. I'm glad I'm here now.
You got the best seat in the house.
Yeah, I can see everything.
So, trick 4 or 5, currently in sixth place, definitely wants to start changing that and climbing up that leaderboard. We've got Rayssa Leal.
Ah.
Going kickflip, back lip. And like we said before, that's 3 missed tricks. 2 scores have to count from this section of the competition. So it's the pressure's on the next one. And we're coming back to the top of the heat. And we'll be kicking it off with Rose again. Oh, fellow teammate.
Yeah. Does she go back to the heel flip?
What would you be saying to her right now?
Calm down. Just stay on your board no matter what happens. You need one more score.
Yeah, Rose is a tough cookie. Oh,
no.
Way.
Oh, damn.
I thought she had it then. I was like, oh, she's got it. She's done it.
So, Kate, talk about how tuned in this crowd is. Is that playing into the skating and the level?
I mean, the hype is real. Everybody's having a great time. I think the crowd's like, I was just standing there, and they were, like, talking about the tricks during the runs. Like, what's the next one going to be? What are they going to do now? They were trying to call the tricks, and they're really invested in everything and trying to guess the scores. It's really fun.
Yeah, and Mark, you talked about the stands are packed.
Yeah, absolutely.
There's not an empty seat in the house.
So trick attempt 5 of 5 for Pamela. Played it easy there. Gap out to frontside Smith.
Smart.
Yeah, but we did see that in the run section, didn't we? So I don't think it's going to get the score that it could get, but that's playing it safe. Currently in that 8th place position, 137.82. And to get up onto that podium to 224.47, it's kind of out of reach.
I think, but she'll get some high points at least because, I mean, Mamiji doesn't have her 4th trick. Or third score, and then Funa's third score was a board slide on the bump to rail. So
yeah,
it could get her into the 4th plate position.
And the next street competition is going to be the World Championships in Japan. So people are just getting scores on the board and then going to try and bolster it out there as well, right?
Yeah, I mean, that one's going to be a big one.
Yeah.
Yeah, and you see, it's like I was, you know, people who are normally just stoked to make it to the finals, but 50,000 points for first place, so there's a lot on the line.
Yeah, and Pamela jumped up into 4th place as we move on to Coco Yoshizawa. Oh, so close.
Should have waxed the wheel bites a little bit. Yeah, it's too low to get off of that trip. But she got really close on that.
That's tough.
Coco with 2 very reasonable scores on the board already, so she had the luxury of maybe trying something different to try and improve on it. And the thing is, when you get your tricks done, then you're like, okay, I've landed the 2 best tricks first go. What do you do then? You're like, well, do I try something crazy or something maybe I've never landed?
Yeah, yeah, it's like, what are you going to do?
Ramiji Nyjah needs to get
this
done.
Yeah, this is an important
wow.
score.
There you go.
And she gets it.
Wow, he's chilling on that too.
Yeah.
Yes, that's the thing with Ramiji. Arms by the side.
I love
just
it.
Just
super relaxed.
Absolutely asleep at the wheel and Speed. Just makes it look so, so good. See what that score's going to look like. 83.99, currently in sixth place. I think that's definitely going to change.
Yeah.
Here's that replay. Almost Ooh. Overturned it a little bit there.
That's just the way she does it.
Yeah.
I think she was confused on how the other ones didn't work out because she's got it so chill.
And I mean, we've seen her do it on longer rails, haven't we? So, yeah. I mean, that's gnarly to spin your board into a longer board slide so hard. And maybe she's just like, oh, this is just a bit too short.
First place.
86.91 wow. and jumping into that first place position.
So she didn't need to flip it.
Wow. So
there it is.
Taking it.
That's going to be tough to beat.
10-point lead.
Back to Paige Hind.
I wonder what's next.
Yeah, we saw that switch 50-50. That got the 91.15 coming in. Switch again.
Yeah, switch
again. Evil, maybe?
You yeah. called it. Yeah.
There you go. You know your Paige well.
Yes. I love Paige's tricks.
Yeah, switch, feeble grind. And I mean, this shows the evolution of women's skateboarding right here. We're seeing more and more switch tricks being done.
No.
And that technical difficulty is just, you know, exploding at the moment. And, you know, yourself as well, you're right on the forefront of that. And it's great to see for me. I think it's so exciting.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, it's so sick to see everybody doing so many different tricks. And Paige is really stepping it up with the switch game. I mean, switch 50 down that rail is insane.
Yeah, that is
I can't even begin to think about it.
And how is it moving along into four phases of competition? You got qualifying, quarterfinals, semifinals, finals.
Yeah. I mean, she was doing the switch 50s every time in her runs on the bumped bar, and they were looking really chill. Yesterday in practice, she pulled up, no warm-up, first try, first trick, switch 50, bumped bar. I'm like, whoa, okay.
Yamika, hold up.
That was close.
That was all or nothing then, wasn't it? She was like, I'm staying on this.
I need to get it.
I'll land this primo. Doesn't matter.
It didn't want to go.
In that second place position, looking good. And Paige jumped up into that third place position, 243.93 on the board. So
last skater.
That is it. Last skater. Trick attempt 5 of 5 for the Brazilian.
She's been Rayssa. In this situation.
Come on, Rayssa. You can do it.
Let's go.
This is a crucial score right here.
Yeah. One score on the board. You have to have two in this section to go with one score from the run section as well. Here we go.
Oh no,
missing the kickflip, backside
so
lip slide. You can see how much it meant to her. Pamela running in there as well. She's all smiles anyway.
Ah, that was so close.
I mean, to make it into this final through four different competitions basically is impressive enough.
It's a long way.
And what I think is great about all of these competitions and skateboarding, you know, we've got this little special thing that no one else has got. The camaraderie that is on the platform. You know, you see people going up and congratulating other people who have knocked them out of the competition. Mm-hmm. And that's something special, right?
Yeah, I love that about skateboarding. It's something that I think is one of the most beautiful things about the sport. Everybody's just happy for everybody.
Yeah, you don't see football, basketball players rooting each other on in a competition.
I think it's more so a competition between you and yourself than you and everybody else.
That makes sense. It's the family vibe.
Yes.
There you have Ramiji.
Boom.
And this is our final standings for our World Skateboarding Tour Lausanne, Switzerland finals. Rose down there in the eighth place. And then in the middle, we got Coco, Yoshizawa, and Paige jumping into that third place spot as we move through.
So
Yamika Oda and out there in first place, 259.81 points, Ramiji Nyjah. So, so important, that last trick, all the pressure was on.
Yes.
Wow. And here is our highlights from our top three. Paige coming straight in with that backside 50-50 in the front. Smith, great skating all weekend from Paige, right?
Really great.
Yeah, I like the hustle.
Yeah. Momiji's face there. She was stoked.
There's the cab aerial. It's good the way she switched things up from yesterday as well and sort of maybe held a little bit back.
Yeah.
The switch front board and the switch 50, I think that was a difference maker. That got her into the podium position.
Yeah, that's never been done before by any girl in a contest like this.
And how solid was that landing? It was perfect.
I haven't seen that in the men's field either.
Right. Yeah, no, a lot of people are doing that trick.
So second place, we got Yumika Oda. Started off with that front side blunt slide all the way along that long rail. And then that front feeble had an issue in run number one, but came back in run number two and really, really shined.
Yeah. You see the stoke on her face there. That overcrooks.
This was insane.
Yeah, this is where things went absolutely bonkers. God. That is perfect.
Came out of nowhere.
No one's going to do that better. And look at that. Wow. Proper
emotion.
She didn't
think it was going to happen first try. She was like, I'll try one.
And here is our first place, Momiji Nyjah from Japan.
Yeah, wow. Winner yet again. She is just dominating.
And that arms down by the side style, just absolutely chilling. And I love seeing that little smile then on the kickflip as well. It's really great to see.
There's that Suski grind.
I like the way she does that.
And here it is, signature trick.
That's what sealed the deal for her there.
Well, Kate, thank you so much for hanging out with us in the booth.
We're going to
let you go relax,
me.
Watch the men's.
Great to see you. Thank you very much.
Big love.
We are going to take it back down course side with Samantha Bruce.
Hello there. We are now with Momiji, the number one winner. So, Momiji, thank you very much. Congratulations. Please tell us more, about what it feels like to be in first place, because in Rome, you came eighth place. Tell us more about that.
She's very happy. I'm very happy.
And so, obviously, we just saw that there was a big battle between the Japanese. Everybody was fighting for top position. Can you tell us what that's like? Are you guys friends, or is it everybody just is hungry to be in first place?
We were encouraging each other. If we made a make, we obviously congratulated each other.
Thank you very much and congratulations.
Arigato.
Thank you very much, Sam. Great to hear from Momiji there.
Congratulations, Momiji.
Yeah.
Big win there.
What a great final, Chris. So much good stuff went down. But for me, the kickflip frontside feeble was the highlight.
That was definitely a highlight. I mean, we saw the surprise on Yumika's face. That was laying it all on the line there. Puts her on the podium.
Yeah, and they're all trying to get those important points for the road to Paris 2024. We've got our men warming up on the course for our men's finals. Don't go anywhere. This one's going to be absolutely bonkers. Are you keeping it real? I'm calling shotgun, wanna see my baby run. Yeah, I wanna. Are you working the field? You're in my playground, throwing back the funk sound. I sidestep, feeling fly. I'm all in, take it high. Oh, what's the word on the scene? We've been kicking up the dust, if you know what I mean. We got a good thing going. We got a good thing going on.
So, like we mentioned, we've got our men's
finals coming up very, very soon. But we were lucky to step away from the competition for a little while and catch up with Swiss skateboarder Simon Stricker to find out what it's like to skate in Switzerland.
The Olympic qualifiers is happening in Lausanne. What's it like to have such a big competition like that here?
I mean, I think it's great for Switzerland because it's been a while since a big competition like that happened in Switzerland, you know? So now I already heard from the kids, look, they're super hyped up, like seeing them pros, you know, they get inspired for sure. That's really cool.
The skate scene here in Lausanne is like pretty big. So it's growing up, like a lot of new skaters are in. And yeah, it's pretty cool to see the progression here. And here we are at La Fièvre, pretty cool outdoor and indoor skate park.
For the people from Switzerland, it has got to be like super sick, you know? And then to see that people like Nyjah just come here and hang out with the kids, like it's like not a big deal. It's really cool.
Big competition to happen here was the Grand Prix. Do you know about that?
I heard about it now, but I was too young.
Grand Prix marked all the skaters from Switzerland, Lausanne, remember, and it was one of the best contests. People really, like all the Americans, they all talk about Grand Prix, first contest that I implement, like the real spots. It was really like, whoa, this is such a good idea. So people had like the best memories of this contest, like of the old generations. But of course, the level of skating and the type of caliber of skaters that we have now is way bigger, you know, like they're superstars now.
Killian is one of the best skaters in Switzerland, and I think everybody know him all over the world because he have a really unique style, unique tricks. He didn't make it to the quarterfinals, but I think he got a banger after the competition in the park, so he's really stoked about it.
Did you do it for you, or were you just trying to please the crowd?
No, it was more like for me because it was like one of the biggest switch tray I ever did. I was trying to like level up on my switch trays.
And you landed it, and how did that feel?
Oh, I felt amazing. For me, the priority is just have a good time, have fun, and not get too much like caught up in the pressure or like too much, too serious, you know? Keep a smile.
Yeah, always.
Yeah, Killian's so good.
I like that attitude, having fun out there.
Yeah, and just leveling up. I mean, everybody's having that personal battle with, you know, trying to just improve themselves, right?
Yeah, we heard Kate talk about it. It's you're competing against yourself mostly.
You can see that. Nyjah Huston getting warmed up.
Yeah, the focus, but also smiling, having a good time.
And he was one of the people that we caught up with earlier on to take a chat about our Rome competition, which was the last one we were at.
I love Rome. It was the second year that I went there, and it was wonderful. Unfortunately, I couldn't get the podium. I ended up in fourth. I missed up one trick in my run, and nowadays, if you miss one trick in a run, it's really hard to get the podium because the level of skateboarding is really high.
Yeah, level of skateboarding, like, since the five past year was, like, going so up and so fast. I've been first on the qualifier and semis, and then I didn't do what I wanted to do during the finals. I don't really know what happened to that this day. I don't know, some days you're not in and don't skate really good. Yeah, Nyjah was there too, he skate really good. He deserved like a first place, and I think everybody skate actually really good. And so that was a good event again.
I wouldn't say I had something to prove in Rome. I think I was just extra juice to be back skating contests. This year, I did a couple different tricks than I did the previous time skating there. So yeah, that place works out good for me.
This course is a little bit different than Rome. Rome, the big session was really, really long, the rails. This one is a little different. It's more like down rail.
This is a little more high speed, bigger quarter pipe, the middle obstacle, you can carry some more speed through, which I like.
Good stirs, good gaps. For me, I like that, so.
any course like that has good flow and it helps putting together a good run. I feel great on my board right now. So I would say I feel even much better now than I did in Rome. I'm very like conditioned to skate hard right now.
Yeah, Nyjah really is on the top of his game right now, Chris.
Yeah, I love how much he's smiling. It seems like he's just comfortable rooting on the rest of the field. He's got a great attitude.
Yeah, and Aurelien's been looking really good out there. He absolutely smashed it in yesterday's semifinals, right?
Yeah, he is a fierce, fierce competitor.
Woo. Wow, look at that.
Nolly flip, yeah.
Imagine that being your
warm-up. We saw him kind of do that in semifinals and not get the pop he needed, but he just powered through it. He's got so much strength.
Yeah, and our semifinals was definitely something special. We were talking to Jake Ilardi, and he was saying, this is like the finals, just to get through. And I think that really felt like that, yeah?
Oh, yeah. I mean, the level of skateboarding in that semifinal was just unbelievable.
And it's time to check out our semifinal recap for our men yesterday.
Men's semi-final heats were stacked with big names and was bound to deliver surprises as only 8 out of 16 advanced to the finals. World ranking number 2 Gustavo Ribeiro bailed both of his runs. In the best tricks of frontside nose blunt slide, nolly flip out and gap to frontside nose blunt nolly heel flip out weren't enough to land in the top 8. American trio Jagger Eaton, Braden Hoban and Jamie Foy also didn't make the cut. Skater of the Year 2017 Foy, though, wowed the crowd with one of the best recoveries we've seen in the second run. Of the 5 Japanese skateboarders who have qualified for the men's semi-finals, 4 have made it through to the finals and they brought a take-no-prisoners dimension to tonight's contest. Yuto Horigome did so with the tricks that skateboarding's lexicon of description is struggling to keep up with. Kari Natsuki is doing hill flip backside lip slides every single time. The lesser-known talents of Toa Sasaki and Yukito Aoki are bringing their own large-trousered stealth consistency to bear on a field of familiar names who they beat to progress into the finals. Interestingly, however, although half of the finalists are Japanese, none of them made the top 3. Those positions fell to the better-than-ever Nyjah Huston, who outdid his 90 score on Best Trick 2 by following up with an incredible nolly heel flip backsmith on the 9-stair rail, gaining a massive 93 score on the board. Position 2 went to the powerful street-skating thoroughbred Giovanni Viana, and position 3 to Aurelien Giraud, who is looking razor-sharp and deadly.
Yeah, that top 3 were all absolutely feeding off each other. And here is our start list for today's finals. We'll be kicking it off in reverse order with Richard Turi from Slovakia, Yukito Aoki in there, Kairi Natsuki, Giovanni Viana. I'm stoked that he's in that second place position as we go through. Just in front of Frenchman Aurelien Giraud, and out there in that first place position and skating last today, we have Mr. Nyjah Huston.
Yeah, here we see Richard Turi getting prepared. And I got to mention Giovanni Viana, his trick selection is just so, so unique. I'm excited to see what he's got here.
Yeah, it's unique, but he's choosing some really, really awkward tricks, right? Yeah. Like things that no one else wants to do.
Yeah, yeah. I'm not going to blow it by calling it out, but you will see some mind benders.
So that's the end of practice right there. We've got our course manager out there getting everybody ready. So each skater will get 2 45-second runs, followed up with 5 trick attempts anywhere on the course. And we're going to be kicking it off with run number 1 and putting 45 seconds on the clock for Richard Turi out of Slovakia. Dropping in on that high section. Straight into the handrail. Heel flip, frontside lip slide to start your run. That's a good way to start, Chris.
That is a very unique and difficult trick. Nice, powerful nose grind.
Wow, kickflip, backside, tail slide. So he's flipped in to two different tricks, once on a handrail and once on the bumper ledge.
And there's another one. Wow. You flip nose slide. There's bump to hover.
Not many people flipping into three tricks during their run, Chris.
No.
So he's flipped his board four times now.
Whoa!
Hanging on to that one, the backside 180 fakie nose grind. 5 seconds. Time for one last trick.
Big spin heel board. Yes! Amazing.
I don't think I've ever seen anyone flip into so many tricks on their first run or in any finals run.
Yeah, over half of his tricks he flipped into.
But one thing, having said that, that limits those flip-in tricks during the best trick section, right? Because you don't want to repeat anything.
Yeah, yeah, that's going to be tough to top, but it's going to give him a great score.
Yeah, Thomas Vinter giving him a big handshake there, and that's just where we kicked it off. Heel flip, front side, lip slide. Wow, Chris.
That is just an awkward, difficult trick. It does it so smooth.
Heel flip, no slide on that bump out to the downside of the hover.
And yeah, Richard, kind of a relatively new name to the game, and there was over 100 competitors in the men's field. So to make it through to the top eight, props to Richard.
Yeah, like we said before, it was such a battle to get through. 78.19 coming through there for run number one.
Okay.
I thought it might have been a bit higher.
I would have broke that into the 80s, but...
But they also know what Richard's capable of. So Toa Sasaki from Japan.
Nice. Back nose bump for the first trick. That is super risky. Bailing on the 360 flip, which is so much easier for him.
That tail slap on the front side ollie was great. Backside tail slide.
He looks composed, even though he had that fall.
Yeah, good recovery. And I was going to say, I hope I see one of those big backside 360s. And there it is. 15 seconds left.
Wow.
That was such a good nollie heel flip there,
yeah.
Chris.
With this point system, man, it is crucial to recover from a fall.
See him taking a little bit of breathing time there on the axle stall to gear up for that bigger spin flip front board. So that's run number one of two out of the way for Toa.
Yeah, Toa's definitely capable of putting that entire run together. One more shot at that.
Yeah, to finish it with the biggest spin flip front board, that's something else. That's going to see that score rocket. And I think everyone knows what Nyjah's capable of. We saw it yesterday. So everyone's just throwing everything they've got at these run sections.
Yeah, and as I mentioned, I'm just really impressed with the skateboarders these days. When they bail, they almost step it up. You know what I mean? Like, it's the level of skating goes higher after a bail, which we didn't used to see back in the day. You bailed one or two tricks, and your mind was just out of the game.
Yeah, 38.66 coming through for Toa's run number one. And we now have run number one for Yukito Aoki. Starting off with that awkward nollie feeble, Chris.
I love Yukito's style and trick selection. Nice backside Smith grind.
That sets him up for that. Well, he was going frontside 180 switch crook, but
kind of
the tail slide fake.
Not sure he locked in on that, but at least it wasn't a fall.
Wow,
there's that 360 flip 50.
Every go on that, pretty much, Chris. I don't think you've seen him fall off many of those. Lovely frontside ollie on the quarter pipe. It's quite mellow, that quarter pipe. You can hit your tail really well.
Wow.
Yeah, backing up Momiji with the crooked grind nollie heel.
Wow, nollie big spin, lip slide to end, back lip slide to end things off with a bang.
That is going to be the confidence booster as you move forward through the competition, that getting that kind of run together.
Yeah.
Wow.
That is that last trick. You do not see that trick.
Yeah, and there's a reason.
Nollie big spin,
so
back
nollie.
Whip.
Yeah. And the thing is with that, you're waiting for it to spin behind you. So you're just like, hey, come round.
Blind.
And then you've got to put your feet on it and take it to the lip slide. So started it off with the nollie crook. Nollie feeble.
Yeah, another super unique trick you don't often see.
And then that 360 flip frontside 50-50.
And here we have that nollie big spin back lip.
Yeah, stamping that landing. And How important is it to land your tricks? You know, you can do a trick, but 82.11 coming through there. How important is it to land your tricks perfectly, you know, with both feet over the bolts?
Yeah, I mean, these days, the judges are definitely docking a sketchy landing. You know, back, I would say, the 90s, 80s, you know, you could kind of sketch something out, but these days, judges want to see a trick landed perfectly.
Yeah, for sure. Kairi Netsuki. Wow, there's a way to get going. Crook Nolly flip out. Taking it back round to the big handrail. Back nose blunt. This is looking really good for Kairi Netsuki.
Let's see this cap heel flip. Got it! In the books.
You're not supposed to have that trick that consistent.
That's typically a vert trick.
That big spin front side board slide to fakie was a thing of beauty as well. Did you see how well he did that?
Yeah, he was unfazed. It just happened well. What?
Whoa! Okay.
Back heel flip, back lip.
Back
okay.
Smith on the buzzer
wow.
as well. That was a heavy, heavy run right there, Chris.
That you know, I'm no judge, but that is the best run we've seen from the men's field so far.
What we're seeing so far as well is that we're seeing best tricks going into the run section.
Yeah. We 100% are. I mean, you know, 10 years ago, these were like video part enders. And now they're just atypical tricks.
There's that backside nose blunt slide. And then scooting over to get that.
Yeah, I love that cab heel flip. That's a tough one on small transition.
And the judges know that. You know, no one's doing that because that's so high risk.
Yeah, and that was him coming out of that backside heel flip, back lip. Ending things with a bang.
I think this is going to be a banger of a score as well. 85.48 coming through your new leader, Kairi Netsuki.
Rightfully so.
Heavy, heavy score there. Where does he go from that, though?
Coming out of Japan.
Okay, qualified fourth through to the final. We've got Yuto Horigome coming in. Switch frontside tail slide. Now he started off the run yesterday. 360 flip, 50-50.
I love how relaxed Yuto looks, man. And with how difficult his tricks are, it's heavy.
Yeah, just like that one right there, Chris. Makes the hardest tricks look really easy.
Yeah, I mean, Yuto along with Nyjah has just dominated competition as of late. Wow. Nolly,
back nose
blunt, 360, 270, all the way around the board. So impressive. No one else is doing that.
Front side, blunt side to fakie. Don't get lulled into a false sense of security. All of these tricks are really hard. He's
super
just making
hard.
Them look
he makes
easy.
Him look easy.
Wow!
Nolly heel footboard. That is a rare miss.
Yeah, gutted he didn't get that one. That would have been a beast of a score. And like I was saying, all of those tricks were awkward pretty much, right?
Yeah, Yuto's got his own trick vocabulary. You know, as broadcasters, you often stumble. You're like, Nolly 270 to... What was that?
Just call it the Yuto. So there's one of them. And he likes those tricks where you're completely blind until you're in the on or sliding or grinding, like that one there.
Yeah, I don't see anyone else doing that trick. Nolly all the way around, 270 to board. You could arguably say 360 Nolly.
Just coming off of that Nolly heel flip board slide down the big nine stair, waiting for that score to come in. Not going to be what he's after, 69.52, okay. But that's a great score with a fall, Chris.
Yeah, you see the look on his face. He's going to best that.
Okay, third place qualifier. We're into our top three from semis. You can hear the crowd absolutely screaming for Aurelien Girard.
Exploding for the Aurelien. One of Europe's finest right there.
Yeah, we're in the French part, or the French-speaking part of Switzerland. Okay, trick number one. Yeah, straight out to that blunt slide.
I first became aware of Leal at Simple Session Contest in Estonia almost a decade ago, and he was just a little grom, but was such an amazing skater even back then.
Yeah, let's see if he gets
this.
He's
got so much power.
Oh, just not quite getting that 360 ollie round. Just wondering if he was going to do the big 360 flip. He might be saving that, and he's definitely switched up his run. 360 flip lip. Coming down to final
he
five
had
seconds.
The Oakland A's shorts previously. Now he's rocking Dodgers shorts, giving LA some props. I'm down with that. And not the run he wants. Aurelian can put all that together for sure.
But what I like about him is, okay, falls off something, he's quick, back up. Right, I'm back in the game. I'm going to do this. I'm going to do this anyway. It's like, you know, he knows that's not what he wanted to happen, but it's I'm still going to get some stuff done.
Yeah, he mentally can recover really quickly. You're right on that.
28.38 coming through there for Aurelio, run number one score. As we take it over to the second place qualifier through to our finals. Out of Brazil, we have Giovanni Viana.
Yeah, Giovanni's another one that has like his own trick vocabulary. See, fakie ollie hurricane. I've never seen anyone else do that trick.
That blunt slide goes all the way to the end of that long rail as well. Slides every inch.
Nice nolly crooked grind,
and that's a big step up to get the nolly crook on for sure. And there's one of his other trademark tricks, the half cab frontside Smith grind,
nolly front nose. All right,
he's looking so comfortable on his board right now.
Switch back lip, he needed that final trick here.
Really well timed as well.
Cab front nose to Fagie. Oh,
perfect.
Wow.
Absolutely perfect, Chris.
I mean, he looked unfazed. The pressure of that, to try that for your last trick is just nuts.
We slid up to like a little rock fakie on the bank and just rode in. Looked like he was like, ah, you know what, whatever. Yeah. And then, boom, cab frontside nose slide down a nine stair rail.
Yeah, to cab and land perfectly on the nose. Board slide is one thing. Nose slide. There's inches there. You have to do that so perfectly.
Yeah, started off with that fakie ollie hurricane. Here's that half cap Smith. Look how far away he's got to ollie to get that thing to go round and land into a Smith.
Yeah, and you really have to land on top of this handrail with the vertical slats and how it sort of shoots you into the ground. You got to be on top completely. And there was that mind-blowing cab front nose.
80.38. He's happy with that one. That sees him currently in that third place position. As we take it on to the last rider before we take it back to the top of the heat for runs two. We got run number one and 45 seconds on the clock for the amazing Nyjah Huston.
Yeah, top competitor in the street game for quite a long time.
Flip backside lip slide, gapping over, going back the other way with a 360 flip.
Won our Rome event, recovering from an injury, and killing it out here as well.
Wow.
Gap out to back nose blunt, yeah. Powerful
heavy tricks
power
going
hanging
down.
On there.
Whoa! Hanging on. Waiting for that one to fold round. Oh. There, kickflip front board. Oh, wow. So coming round for last trick into the big section.
Get it, Nye.
Wow. Fakie 5-0 down the big nine rail. All smiles from Nyjah Huston right there.
That cab flip was after time. So that bail, I do not think will factor in.
That was good.
He's like, so sketch. Not to us, man.
Sketchy.
But we've talked about it before, how you'll stay on things that you usually wouldn't because it's the competition. And that certainly was an example of it there. That switch frontside flip was crazy.
I mean, I think the guys that hang on to those tricks, even when they're a bit sketchy, like Nyjah or Aurelian, they're just so powerful that they can power through a bit of a misstep.
Yeah, for sure. And they can change at the blink of an eye. Here we go, look, waiting for it to flip round.
Almost didn't come around.
Caught it primo midair.
I dare to say, like, when things are slightly sketchy and you just show the determination, I think it sort of factors in. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's not a fall. It's a make. You made it happen.
Yeah, for
sure.
I
wouldn't dock him for that.
Full commitment. 86.88 seeing Nyjah Huston back in familiar grounds of first place.
Judges counted those scores that he believed were a bit sketchy for himself.
So we're taking it back to the top of the heat where we started with Slovakian Richard Turi. 78.19 for run number one. Going to want to improve on that one. Are we going to see it change up, Chris?
I haven't seen a huge bag of tricks. The tricks he does have are super unique, but he's yet to really surprise the judges, so we'll see.
So there's that kick flip back tail. It's all been the same so far. Heel flip, no slide.
Yeah, judges are not looking for repeated runs, or even repeated tricks for that matter.
Sure. There's the kick flip back over the driveway, making his way back up on the big section.
Woo! Back 20 nose grind, coming out back around straight. That's difficult.
So, wow,
there it
getting
is.
It done again. Same run, but
yeah.
Better execution on the back 180 nose grind.
Yeah, 180, yeah, that's the one addition. I don't know how much that steps up on the 78.19.
Yeah, we have got that repetition rule. So if you repeat tricks, especially in the trick section that you've done in run section, it starts getting knocked down slightly. So the score you could have potentially got, you're gonna lose. Maybe a couple of points.
Yeah, you
gotta
hold a couple of tricks in the bag.
So here's that recap for Richard Turi. He'll flip frontside lip slide down the big nine stair.
If you start the competition off with all your best tricks, you kind of have nowhere to go. So it begins hard to crack into that top three.
Saw that heel flip. No slide as well. 78.87. So, yeah, there's that slight improvement. But if the first run was like that, it would have been a higher score, I believe. So the repetition has hurt that slightly.
Yeah, he's got to pull into his bag of tricks a little deeper.
So Toa Sasaki back in. Starting off with that backside nose blunt. 360 flip. That's where he fell last time. So we're already ahead of himself. Frontside kick flip on the quarter pipe as well. Toa's got a good transition game, right?
Yeah, that frontside flip was impressive. Nice front blunt there, getting speed out of it. Big back 360. This is a great run.
Whoa.
Nolly heel hanging on.
Yeah, got it done though. So composing himself before last trick.
This is crucial.
We all want to see this one. Finishing it off the run. Wow! Perfect as well, Chris.
Bigger flip, frontside board. Wow, that's a risky last trick. We saw him fail it last run. Props to resetting and hanging on. He's got to be happy with that run.
Yeah, great set of tricks within that whole run. Flips in, had a bit of everything.
And, you know, it almost came together in the first run, had a couple of bails. There's a 38. So definitely stepping it up.
That's that lovely 360 flip.
No deck check whatsoever.
And here's that big flip.
Look at that
board.
That foot position, it's just how.
The thing is, when your board's spinning around that much, you've got to wait for it to go round, you know.
And with how steep that rail is, that is such a difficult trick to try.
Boom, 89.66.
Wow.
Highest score so far of this section of competition. And your new leader is Toa Sasaki.
Amazing.
Hell of a run. So that's put the cat amongst the pigeons now, mate, because everybody else has seen what's just happened, and now they have to adjust on the fly.
Yeah, we saw in Nyjah's interview previously. He builds off seeing the other skaters and what they do. So we'll see if he changes things up to try to get on top of the leaderboard again.
So Yukito Aoki back in for run number two. Lovely backside Smith, taking it all the way to the end of that rail.
There it is.
Oh, okay. And switching it up from yesterday with the 180 out as well.
270 switch crooks and then reverting out the last second. Perfect. 360 flip 50.
Hang on. Keep it going, Yukito. Big frontside ollie.
Like how he kind of alley-oops that.
Well, oh, did you see the foot adjustment? Yeah. Halfway through there, he was like, oh, I need to get my foot over a little bit further.
There it is. Oh, no!
No, no, no. We wanted to see that clean run. I thought that was just going to happen, that last one. He's got that every go. So surprised. So what we've seen here is he missed the 360 flip over the driveway in the first run. No, sorry. Missed one, the 180 out. He did the frontside tail slide, sorry, on the frontside ollie switch crook. Changed it up on that one, but then missed the last trick, Chris.
Yeah, yeah.
So do you think it's... Well, yeah, okay.
Yeah, so 75. Obviously getting docked.
Yeah.
But hey, that run section score of an 82.11, that's strong.
Yeah,
moving
definitely
into best trick.
Yeah. So we are taking it on to current third place position, Kairi Netsuki.
Whoa! Front crook to Beck Smith. Oh, wow. Crooked grind, nollie flip.
So this is that variation we were talking about, changing up the run.
Changing things up, 100%.
Yeah. Judges want to see it. They want to be shocked and surprised.
Back noseball. Yeah, Kairi is skating intelligently right here. Is that cab heel flip? That's one I don't mind seeing repeated.
Big spin, frontside, boardside, fakie.
He looks on it. 10 seconds here.
Heel flip position, heel flip, backside lip slide. Time for one last one. Backsmith.
Yeah.
Wow. Okay.
Stoked.
So, similar or same run apart from that first trick, right?
Yeah. Yeah. Everything. I want to say, did he switch up his first two tricks? I want to say, but yeah. I think he mixed things up just enough. Yeah. And obviously, making that.
There it
back
is.
Back heel, back lip at the end of his run is going to score huge.
Yeah, and to go into the crooked grind nollie flip as well.
Yeah.
You know, everybody within this section of the competition are flipping their board in every run into a trick or out. And that's incredible. So 87.88 coming through, taking that score through to the trick section.
Proper.
So, staying in Japan, we have the absolutely phenomenal Yuto Horigome.
Oh,
missing that 360 flip 50-50, but he's got the hustle to come back across
the
course.
Hey, we've seen it before. Yuto has often come back from, like, you know, meet fairly mediocre run scores to just dominating and winning with the best trick.
He's currently got that 69.52. I don't think he's going to improve on that one, so he's going to need to rely on those last tricks for sure, Chris.
Yeah. If anyone's got some surprise tricks in his game, it's Yuto.
Yeah, and I mean, he won the Olympics on that trick format, you know, just with the best tricks. Now we have this format of having to have that run section score back
you up. That makes things a bit more challenging if you don't have a run section score in the 80s.
I mean, it's still a good score, 69.52. We'll see where we go with this. And I mean, some amazing tricks within that anyway, even with the fall.
Yeah, I love how laid back Yuto's style is.
Here's those replays for Yuto.
Yeah, nollie 270 all the way around the board slide.
So, so awkward. You have to really wait for that truck to get round. And getting it done this time, the nollie heel flip, board slide.
The relaxed look on that land.
Good after
Steve. Unbelievable.
75.41. So, yeah, improving on that first run score. As we take it back to France and Aurélien Giraud. 28.38 is not enough to be going through to the trick section. So, pressure is on for Aurélien.
Yeah, 100%.
Looking pretty comfortable so far, Chris.
Yeah, so far he's three tricks landed. He's gonna add in a little bit of difficulty, which I'm sure he's gonna do. Look how hard he's pumping.
Massive. Right, there you go. That's where we saw him fall on run number one. That's going to be the confidence booster he needs as we move forward. 360 flip, lip slide.
Yes.
We saw him doing the hard flip frontside board slide yesterday at that point, so yeah. Changing up the run. And he's putting it down on the rail instead.
No.
Oh, we really wanted to see that. You can see he's gutted to not make that one.
Yeah, hard flip, front board. Well, the pressure's on for the best trick section for Aurelien.
Yep, 28.38. That's definitely going to be improved on, though, Chris.
Yeah.
But how much
yeah.
and whether it's going to be enough, we don't know right now. Let's check out those replays for Aurelien.
Boom. Cleared that gap by a good 2-3 feet there.
Yeah, he could have gone way further. Here's that 360 flip lip slide.
Here we go. There's that hard flip front board that just got away.
Yeah, heavy impact off the end of that rail, like we keep saying. Not quite getting it round far enough. Waiting for that score to come in. 50.02. You can see the disappointment there.
Yeah.
He's saying, yeah, pressure is really on trick section, but he's got some crazy, crazy tricks for that part of the competition.
Yeah, I'm not even going to call out what we saw in semis. I want everybody to be surprised.
So Giovanni Viana back in, kicking it off with that fakey hurricane down the rail. Blunt slide all the way to the end of the rail.
Yeah, so far sticking with the same line. Let's see if he switches it up.
Yep, there's the switch up straight away on demand for you, Chris. Half cab, frontside Smith.
Nolly front crooks.
That was well styly as well. You see them pushing around that back foot to tweak it over.
Yes. Heel foot front board. So, yeah, switching up his line, which I like to see.
Coming in fakey.
Woo! Wow. Even with that cab front nose to fakey for the ender.
Really switched up that line, getting the nolly big spin backside lip slide in there. And then coming through again with that ender, the cab, frontside nose slide. There's no one doing that trick for a reason. It's real high risk on a round rail, Chris.
Yeah, that was a great run for Giovanni Viana.
Good to see Stefan Laurence out there in the crowd.
Legend. There you called it, that nolly big spin backflip to fakie. Switch things up.
See him stamping that heel flip front board down. He's like, nah, you're coming with me.
Yes,
it's so good how long he slides that for as well, though, Chris.
Yeah. That is. I've mentioned, it's just such a difficult trick. He'll end perfectly on your nose.
So currently in that fifth place position, waiting for it to come in. 87.19.
Right,
he's
right.
Happy with that. So are we. And he's currently sitting in that third place position, which is a really nice place to be.
Oh, yeah, moving into best trick. That's great.
Okay, currently in that fourth place position as he drops in for run number two. Starting off with that crooked grind, we've got Nyjah Huston.
Kick the back lip over the gap rail. Back 180 nose grind. So currently in fourth, had a perfect run. How is he going to switch it up?
Back tail taking it back down. Back nose blunt slide. It's crazy how easy Nyjah makes these tricks look. Switch frontside flip, way better than the last run so far. Kicky frontside board slide.
Yeah, all the tricks are done without the sketch that he felt in that first run.
So coming in fakey. Wow, okay.
Cat back Smith to fakey. Okay, that was a complete surprise.
Yeah.
That was the difference maker right there.
Yeah, we saw it in his qualifying run yesterday, or semi-finals run, the half cab, backside Smith grind, backside 180 out. That's such a gnarly trick, and it's definitely the way to end your run, Chris.
Yeah. I dare to say that tops his first run score of an 86.88.
So we're waiting for that score to come through. Some heavy tricks once again from the American. coming back from that injury, it really doesn't seem to have fazed him at all. He is on the top of his game right now.
Yeah, gap, backside nose blunt. Here is that cab backsmith to fakie.
See the focus as he's right now at that then. So gnarly. So what score are we going to get as we see the guys warming up for the trick section where each skater gets 5 attempts at a trick anywhere on the course? I think that's got the judges scratching their heads there a bit.
Yeah. Where do you go? But I think it ups the score. He landed more cleanly, added some difficulty with that last trick.
Yeah, already got that 86.88, which is good enough for fourth place right now. Casually just chucking that in there, Chris, in warm-up.
Yeah, he stays warm. Smart thing to do.
And we're still waiting for that second run score to come through. It's pretty quiet out there on the course, Chris. You can hear a pin drop. Okay, 90 coming through. Big score. And yeah, seeing him back up where he wants to be in that first place position as we move through to best trick. We're going to kick it off where we started in our run section with Richard Turi out of Slovakia very, very soon. So yesterday we saw Nyjah chuck in that first go nollie heel flip backside Smith grind. He said in the interview afterwards he didn't expect to land it. He's only done it a few times. That shows how on form Nyjah is at the moment, right?
Yeah, and it also shows the level of competition. That semifinal was the quality of any finals. To have to throw that down in the semifinals, I mean, it's amazing.
Yeah, for sure. So here's our highlights from Nyjah's run. Kicked it off with that crook, then taking it over to the kickflip back lip. And I love the pop out of that.
Looking just so composed.
There's the kickflip front board.
That ender, yeah.
Yeah, for
that,
sure.
That sealed the deal.
The thing is, Nyjah hustles as well. And I mean, it could be if you sneak in one more trick, especially if it's a high difficulty trick, that could be between first and second place, right?
Yeah. I mean, I would dare to say he's the smartest competitor in the game as far as like paying attention to scores and feeding off other scores of other skaters and trying to come up with something unique.
Yeah, and I mean, that's the thing with this field of finalists that we've got. Really unique tricks that are going down.
Yeah.
You know, Giovanni is doing crazy fakie pop tricks. And then obviously Nyjah as well. But definitely don't rule out the Japanese field either.
Yeah, Yuto Horigome having his own bag of tricks as well as Giovanni Viana.
Yeah, I'll be interested to see Kyrie's trick selection for this as well. I think we're going to be seeing a complete change up in what we saw yesterday, and I really hope there's going to be some different tricks that we've not seen probably ever before in a final, Chris.
Yeah. And I mean, for how well he skated, currently in third place, so that just shows you the level of skateboarding that's going down.
Yeah, definitely one to watch, and I think this is going to be really exciting. We've got our course manager out there saying that Richard Turi needs to get in position. He's just getting a bit of wax on his wheel well there so you don't get wheel bite. That's when you stand on the side of your board and it pinches and stops you from skating. So trick attempt number one of five for the Slovakian, Richard Turi. So best score so far, 78.87. Seeing him in sixth place.
Okay, switching it up. I like that. You saw the heel flip lip, so trying to add some difficulty with the heel flip tail slide.
And we saw that perfect one yesterday, didn't we? It was crazy. But we've got another guest in the booth with us, Chris. Hello, Manny Santiago. Good
up,
to
guys?
See you again, buddy.
Nice. Thanks
What's
for
up,
having
my
me.
Brother?
Thanks for having me.
Yes. Thank you for joining us.
100%.
So how'd you see this shaping up so far, mate?
It's a new group of finalists, meaning like there's some new add-ons, younger age, newer tricks, like Toa right here, who's going to bring tricks like that. So at that point, you can't cut nobody out, because when it's new feet, new tricks, it's like it can go anyway.
Yeah. But we have got that repetition coming into play. He's done that in the run section at the end of his run. So do you think that's going to affect the possibility of getting a higher score?
I think he should get a zero. No, straight up. I think that's one of the things you can't repeat at all.
Okay.
Like, you can't repeat the same trick. If you do it on a different obstacle, then it would be a lower score, because
maybe change it up, take it at fakie or shove it out or something.
But he should get a zero for that. I mean, that's from the rules that I remember.
So 85.14 coming through. So, I mean, it potentially could have got a higher score, but maybe the repetition from the run section.
Yeah. I think they're being even too nice with that 85, if you ask me. If you did it at the end of your run and it's the last trick, it shouldn't be the first trick you try.
So 174.80 on the board as we take it over to Kito Aoki. How easy did he make that look? It's so unfair. Like, this is the thing that is standing out to me, is everybody looks like they're really chilling on the hardest tricks. It's crazy to me.
Well, it's because the level of skateboarding continues to evolve. As much as we think it's not going to get any crazier, every stop it gets a little bit crazier. And then since the contest prior, they know what the tricks people are doing, and they go back to their country, they just go and practice those tricks over and over and over and over and over again.
And Manny, you've been skating in competitions like this for over a decade now. What's it like to just see the change in the level?
It's inspiring. For me, it's inspiring. Inspiring because, as a fellow competitor, it makes you want to be better. It makes you want to be sharper. And it also, when you think the level can't get risen any higher, it does. So then that reminds you of like the work you have to do as a competitor. So it's beautiful, honestly. It's scary too at the same time.
So I just wanted to mention that repetition was for SLS rules, actually. We've got different rules here. You will get your score docked a little bit, but you will definitely still get scored.
So Kyrie with that backside heel flip, back lip over the bump rail.
Yeah, you can't rule Kyrie out. He's got a great trick selection, I feel.
You and talked about
heavy
Manny.
Heel flip game.
Yeah, we talked about it. He did that trick on a different obstacle, so
yeah, reset. Like for him right there, he shouldn't get docked any type of points because it's a completely different obstacle and done to fakie, not to regular. So at that point, it's an even different trick on a different obstacle.
He got a really good slide in on that as well. Long slide.
I feel like now that people see that what had just happened with the bigger flip front board, I feel like you're going to see a lot of repetitions moving forward in the contest unless they adjust that.
So 88.87 coming through for that one. So next up, we've got Yuto Horigome coming in. Someone else who chooses to do the most awkward tricks out there.
Yeah, he has his own private bag.
Like that one there. Like, I mean, the thought of going to do that, even on a curb, is petrifying. But to do it down a 9-stair rail, that is crazy.
The crazy part is that that's just him warming up. That's not even hard for him.
Yeah.
He's just trying to get points till then he can bring out the big weapons.
Yeah, he's just building up that base layer at this point in the competition. But I think this is going to be a pretty big score. We know we've got some really great judges up there. They know what's hard and what's not.
100%.
So here we see it.
Look at how beautiful that is.
Backside all the way around to switch front feeble. You could call that like three different ways.
Yeah, 100%. And also it's like the form of and how he does it. It's so controlled, even like all the way around, the whole trick is controlled. Like he knows where he's at the whole time, and it's a blind trick.
Yeah, and where does he come up with these things? You know what I mean? Like you said, I wouldn't see that on a curve.
Yeah, he just...
92.33. Do you think he thinks, okay, right, everybody's doing these staple tricks, big spins into tricks, or you know, crook nolly flip out is getting a popular one down rails and things like that. He's going, nobody does this, so I'm going to learn that.
Yeah, well, he has to in order to stand out, in order to do and get the tricks and points you need to do something different, or you know what you're going to get scored.
Are we going to see this as scratch, do you think, from
Yeah, we were talking about Manny, how, you know, back, let's say, 90s or early 2000s, you could see a little sketchiness in the landing or hand down.
Yeah.
And it seems like that's out of the game.
No more. Mm. You can't. And if you know you landed sketchy, step off your board. Because it's not worth it.
The rule is if you've put your hand down and you wouldn't have made the trick because you put your hand down, then it's going to be a bail, right?
Yeah, because if not, it'd be a baker, baker maker. Which they made it cool.
Yeah. I mean, depending on your skating, remember, you know what I'm saying?
The bigger guys made it cool to lay with your hands down.
Yeah, and it would add some style. If you saw an Eric Ellington put down a hand, you're like, Steve's.
Yep.
69.03 coming through there. That's a heavy score to actually land like that.
So Manny, what's the vibe like, you know, different these days with the Olympic competition, the points ranking? Has the vibe on the deck changed?
No, we're still, honestly, a majority of us, we're still out there having fun and supporting each other. Like,
wow.
He stepped off.
There's that scratch roll. You know, if you do a trick and you're not happy with it, you can put your hands up in a cross like that to the judges and say, hey, I'm going back. They have to forget that you've tried it. You won't get the repetition rule coming into play.
Yeah, to get maximum, to do it better. Maximum points.
Yeah, it's smart. At the end of the day, like, we want to – that's the hard part. We're skating, so the feeling of riding away is fun, even if it's sketchy. And in this moment, you have to go against everything you believe in. You have to go, wait, I landed sketchy. No, wait, zero. I want a zero, which is weird, but it's part of the game.
There he is. We saw that in practice, and that really is a practice trick to him. That's crazy, right?
Yeah. That's one hit. That's like the trick for Yuto, that nolly back heel is Nyjah's nolly 180 from Feeble. Like, that's exactly what it is for him.
And we've seen Nyjah dominate competitions for over a decade.
Yeah.
Manny, what's the difference maker with Nyjah? Like, how?
I think with him, it's like it stems from his upbringing, like the roots of like what he had to get through to make it and provide for his family. Yeah. So at the end of the day, between that fire and then once you make it, everyone criticizes you, then that fire, and then no matter how good you are, you're not good enough, then that fire, he just has a burning inferno inside that will never, like, it'll be cherry red forever.
That's a great analysis of him.
Yeah. He's got 290s on the board already.
See?
As we take it back to Richard Turi.
That's a repeated trick,
if I'm not mistaken. Just because Toa did that, I guarantee you moving forward, you're going to see a lot of repetition, big section tricks, because now you know you can get away with it. That was not happening the contest before this or the contest before that. That's something that needs to get looked into and changed, because that's not a good way to get points.
Yeah.
As a competitor.
Big spin heel footboard, it's a super difficult trick, but we've seen Richard Turi do it numerous times in competition.
Yeah. And it's not so much him, it's meaning like the competitive field needs to, now that they understand that, I guarantee you it's going to become a thing, and they're going to have a meeting and they're going to have to change it, because it takes away from the fans, it takes away from the skaters, and then now you're just literally shooting a three-pointer. Now it becomes basketball.
Yeah, you know what I feel you.
Wow.
Okay.
Step off.
Is he going to say a scratch?
Nope.
To switch Feeble. I would scratch that.
He doesn't have the experience.
Yeah, he's scratching it there. There you go. I think he was waiting to look at the coach maybe and like get some instruction.
He was like lost for a second.
Yeah, not sure. He was sort of half doing it, but
he didn't even do it up. He did it over here, like.
So Manny, while we got a second, talk about the course a little bit. How is the course out here in Lausanne?
This is one of my favorite courses so far. It has a little bit of everything. The sizing on everything is perfect. There's many ways to skate it, and it's realistic to like a handrail steepness, so I like it.
Keto in for trick attempt, 2 of 5.
How difficult is that 9-stair? We've seen a lot of people kind of not land perfectly and shoot out.
Because it's realistic. A lot of the times now they're building rails and hubba's kind of mellow for the skating versus building skateboarding for us. Now they're building the obstacles so that we can do tricks, but when you make it to these specs where it's like more realistic, then you're having to work for those tricks. So it's actually, I like that they give us different looks versus the same steepness every time.
Kyrie coming in.
We got bringing
straight up there.
Not exactly sure what he went for.
By the sounds of it, something special from the crowd.
Yeah, they were excited.
We got a great crowd out here in Switzerland, haven't we? Like, there isn't a spare seat in the stands at all.
No, this is amazing. The whole festival is amazing. From the, all the Chani did like a demo outside with a bunch of dancers at the course. That was cool. I got to see the locals play. I don't know what the instrument's called.
The big trumpet, horn.
Jumping back. Okay, so that was such a tongue twister of a trick.
Yeah, heel flip, backside, tail slide, big spin.
Big spin out,
Oh, he's going for that.
It was real close.
He's going for that 9.9. He's going for that 90 score.
Okay, trick 2 of 5 for Yuto.
There it is. What's that called?
He's trying to tie himself in a knot.
Yeah.
What's that called? 270 all the way around nose, 180 out.
No, it's the U Tornado. It has a name already. That's the U Tornado. Yeah.
The U Nado.
The U Tornado.
U Tornado. So gnarly.
Wow.
And off the kicker as well. Like, I was up on the course last night looking at that gap, and it's not inviting.
No, not at all.
It's not like, hey, come and do this.
No, it's definitely not. But sadly, he has a low score in the run, so it's going to be really hard for him to crack into the number one spot. So now at this point, I think, depending on what happens, he's just fighting for podium, but not on the top spot.
Yeah, but I think this is going to be a huge score coming up for this one.
Be.
I mean, look how well he did it.
Yeah, that would be like a 96, if it was me, 96, 97, 98, possibly.
You don't see a lot of emotion out of Yuto, so that was a rare...
Oh, good call, 96.95.
Rightfully so.
Yeah.
Wow.
I think that's the highest score of the entire competition.
Yeah,
it is.
Yeah, that is way up there, and that sees him in that first place position with the 264.69.
You heard the crowd just explode there.
Yeah, it went bonkers.
So 4 Japanese competitors in this final, Manny.
It's beautiful. I was just having this conversation with somebody. I said 6 years ago, Japan wasn't even on the map in skateboarding.
Yeah.
6-7 years ago, besides Yuto.
I was talking about, you know, like my generation, it was all U.S. skaters.
Mm-hmm.
And now there's 1 or 2 in the entire competition and in the finals, you know what I mean?
It's beautiful, and I feel like Yuto was the one that opened that door.
Yeah.
He showed them what was possible and what tricks we were able to do. And then once he opened the door for the Japanese community within skateboarding in California, I feel like they took that and were like, oh, we can do this like him, and then...
Yeah, I feel you. And then Kisa Nakamura for Transition came out during the Vance Park Series stuff and really put Japan on the map as well.
It's a beautiful thing. It goes to show that limitations are just created by us.
So Giovanni coming in for trick 2 of 5.
Oh, yeah.
That's scratched to get it done.
So he, good choice on scratching it, huh?
Yeah, 100%. I mean, so. I love that rule's part of the competition. It shows foresight into, you know, how to get the best out of people. And I would say this is some of the best skating I've seen ever from Giovanni right now.
Yeah, he's always, always, always doing wild stuff. And you're like, how are you?
Yeah, take us through this trick, Manny.
Fakie frontside 180, backsmith.
Yeah, or arguably frontside half cab backsmith.
Yeah, there you go.
I mean, again, you can call 100%. That 3 different ways. With Yuto and Giovanni's tricks, it's like there's literally 2 or 3 different ways you can call them.
No,
91.87 is going to be hyped to get that on the board with 3 more attempts at something else. Be interested to see where he goes from there.
I tell you what, though, by the way, it's looking him and Nyjah right now. Are gonna be, if it was up to me and I can like be like the crystal ball predict, they're gonna be the ones battling for the number one spot because of their run score.
Wow.
Okay. Nyjah is just really trying to increase that point score at the moment. That was pretty much picture perfect.
Yeah,
as always, when he puts it in. Earlier on in practice, he was struggling with it a little bit.
Yeah, but
he can just switch it on
that.
When he needs
it. Yeah, the camera wasn't necessarily on him, but we saw him bailing that quite a few times, and then to just come back,
he knows,
make
he
it
knows.
Properly, getting props from Costin.
The GOAT.
Sheesh. And Team USA, rightfully so.
Wow.
Nyjah, our only USA competitor in the final.
Yeah, holding it down for the US of A.
92-71, and that's 3 scores in the 90s.
So Yuto can't get first no matter what he does.
That is incredible skating so far from Nyjah. Manny?
Even Yuto said it, he's tripping. He's like, oh, man, I thought I had a chance.
Thank you so much for joining us again in the booth.
Yeah,
really good to hear your insights into the competition. Yes. Go and enjoy the rest of the comp, mate.
Thank you. I appreciate that.
Brother, appreciate you.
Thank you. So Richard Turi back at the top of the heat.
trick attempt. 3 of 5. One scratched score. 80.15 on there already.
There it is. Go.
Heel flip, frontside, tailside, fakie.
Yeah, mixing things up. That was smart.
Yeah, and I mean, we saw that yesterday, but on every day, that repetition rule is scratched. Every day is a new day.
Yeah, I think Richard, you know, that's going to be sort of the challenge for him, is the similarity of his tricks.
Yeah, but he's holding his own out there.
100%. I mean, anybody in this final, man, to make it this far in the competition, over 100 competitors, the top 8, you got to be proud of yourself.
Yeah, and 2 scores in the 80s there, which is good enough for third place.
Wow, okay.
And I mean,
okay.
Now it's interesting. 3 scores on the board. Is he going to change it up in the last 3 tricks, knowing what everyone else is capable
of?
Yeah,
I think he's going to have to.
There you go. Is. We saw that scratch. Nolly, frontside 180, switch, Smith grind, 180 out. Wow.
Yeah.
What a combo.
I mean, I could understand people coming up with tricks like that on a bench, but on a 9-stair handrail, you know, just tricks that we've never seen, blows my mind.
Yeah, you can hear Tim O'Connor, our live announcer, out there saying, I don't think I've ever seen anyone do that trick.
Yeah.
You know, people do the barley grind. It's the Nolly barley grind, 180 out, isn't it? Such an awkward one to try. And let's check out this score. I think that's definitely got the judges scratching their heads.
Yeah, how do you call that one?
Yeah, but I mean, how do you judge a trick that you may have never seen before? Yeah, 90.88. Good call, Chris. You know, that's good enough to get him in that second place position. But like I was saying, how do you judge a score of a trick that you've never seen anyone do before?
I think it pumps up your score, as we're seeing.
So, Yukito Aoki. There.
Oh, no.
Wow, I was just about to say, there you go. That's going to be what he needed to move away from that. But another 0 score on the board. He's already got one on there, but in a late 70, it's not going to be enough. And you can see he's down there in that 7th place position. And 2 more trick attempts to climb that leaderboard.
Yeah, he started things off with a bang in the run section. And now the challenge is for him to get a best trick score.
So trick attempt 3 of 5 for Kairi Netsuki.
Wow. Going back to that. Yeah, that heel flip, back tail, big spin out.
And like Manny was saying, it's more of a legit handrail. Steep, you know, you've not got that much time to get that big spin out. But 2 more attempts at that trick. You know, maybe one of a safety, and then he might need to step away. But we spoke about it yesterday. That skateboarder's mentality, you can't. You've got to be stubborn to get good at skateboarding.
And let's take a look at Yuto Horigome's best trick scores. 92.33, 96.95. Where do you go from here?
Well, who knows?
Oh,
you go that way. Whoa. I don't think I've seen that one. Not in a competition either.
I've not seen Yuto do that trick either.
And I mean, like Manny said, just when you think skateboarding can't get any better, someone comes along and goes, oh, you haven't seen this trick? Here you go. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah,
That's so good.
Nuts. Okay, so really needing a huge score here. I'm predicting the backside 360 flip.
Well, we saw he was trying to do that hard flip back 180 over the rail. Foot position looks right for it.
Oh.
Wow, he caught it. But
going
it hadn't
for the heel
slipped.
Flip back 180.
It hadn't spanned quite sorry, as fast,
flip.
I think.
Hard flip back 180.
I think he zoomed his board up the ramp there and shot it out into the crowd. There's our third member of the team, Samantha Bruce. Looking a bit concerned there, like maybe nearly got taken out by Aurelian's board. So, 2 more trick attempts and the pressure's on both of those there for Aurelian. Only getting that 50.02 in the run section. That pressure is definitely on for the last two tricks.
That's an uphill battle.
So Giovanni Viana currently in that 5th place position.
What?
Going cab, nose blunt slide, fakie.
Yet another trick I have not seen on a handrail.
So 179.06. That's the last 2 tricks have been bailed.
current leader, and you think about how many new faces we've seen, how many new names we've seen, for Nyjah to stay on top this long, it's mind-blowing.
Yeah, but it just shows, you know, just how good Nyjah is. So trick attempt 3 of 5.
Whoa! Oh,
first go!
Nose blood. That's another one we saw him trying in the background, and I saw him jumping out of some pretty gnarly slams on that attempt.
You can see it on his face. He's like, oh, yeah, here we go.
So how is it, man? I mean, you know what I mean? You can see him bail a couple tricks of attempts in practice, and then when the pressure's on, he always comes through.
Yeah, it's usually the other way around. When the pressure comes on, it's like, oh, it's too much. But Nyjah just...
He skates better.
Yeah. He just can switch it on, and that's a good, decent slide on that nollie heel flip nose blunt slide.
It's like the more heat is on him, the better he skates.
That dude in the background was hyped. Did you see him? He was like, no way! Well, rightly so.
We're seeing a bunch of MBDs out here.
Are we
going to
see another 9? Of course we are. 9-3, 2-3. That is four 90s on the board, Chris.
Furthering that lead, a full 10 points ahead.
275.94 on the board for Nyjah. Wow. Okay, we're going to take it back to the top of the heat and fourth attempt for Richard Turi.
All right,
looks like he's starting a different
see?
Position, maybe. Coming into the bump to ledge. Okay, going varial heel.
Yeah, maybe 5-0, nose maybe? Attempt. I'm not sure. But smart to try to mix it up.
Yeah, I think he knows he's got to change it up and get that wow factor going with the judges, right?
Yeah, yeah, that's 100% how it is. You don't want to repeat the tricks from your run. Just look at Nyjah Huston for an example. Surprising everyone.
So you can see on the screen right now, the highlighted scores are the ones that count so far and the ones you'll carry through for your final standings. Whoa,
Toa.
There you go, woo. Toa hanging on there. Cab, backside nose blunt slide, fakie.
Yes.
Two people trying that right now on the course.
I believe we saw Giovanni.
Yeah, so
trying that.
Giovanni's now going to see the score that comes in for this.
Yeah.
And it might be interesting.
If he
thinks it's not enough, he's going to change it and go for something else. But I definitely think it's going to be enough.
I would say so.
So taking off fakie, which is backwards, you've got to pop over the rail and take it onto the nose of the board, which is the front. Slide right up against that front truck.
Yeah, he's slightly under-rotated, but powered through it.
Yeah, I don't think that's going to hurt that score too much.
Nah.
That's such a savage trick.
I mean, if anything, it's more difficult to not land perfectly 90.
All eyes on the board right now. 89.99.
Okay.
He's like,
maybe a little dark on the sketchiness, perhaps?
Possibly. I mean... But it's right up there. It's as good as a 90, really. So currently in seventh place, we got Yukito Aoki. Really struggling on it, and that means the pressure really is on the fifth and final trick for Yukito. It's all or nothing in the last attempt.
Yeah, people at this point battling for position with the point score.
How
adding
much
up,
do you think
leading us to Paris?
Nyjah's got in people's heads right now with what he's doing. You know, it'd be hard to ignore it.
Yeah. I definitely think it gets people in people's head.
Yeah. Kairi Netsuki. Okay, pressure's on for him as well, going for that heel flip, backside tail slide, big spin. I mean, if that happens, that's exactly what he needs to jump up. Will it be enough to take out Nyjah? I'm not sure, but I mean, it will be a very, very big score, though.
Yeah, 100%. And, you know, getting back to that, I think Nyjah actually adds to the level. I think he might, you know what I mean? It's like, you're like, wow, okay, this is the level. This dude just did a heel flip nose blunt slide.
Yeah. So, Yuto. Oh, I was going to say it earlier. We've seen it in the latest video part. Are we going to see him step it up? Yuto really, really... showing that he's getting pushed forward by Nyjah.
Yeah, so that nollie, we've seen him do the nollie 270 board, so trying to add in a nollie heel flip there, that would be an amazing trick to see.
So
pressure's on for Aurelion.
Two last trick attempts for Aurelion. He needs to get this one out of the way. Here we go. So much speed. No, not getting the flick on the board. And that means it is all going to count on that last trick. We're seeing a repeat of Rome right here. You know, qualifying really high up. He was first as he qualified through. First in the semis, skated last, and it didn't come together for him. I would love to see him get that last trick done.
Yeah, yeah, 100%.
So fourth trick of five for Giovanni Viana from Brazil.
Almost every trick starts fakie.
Oh, okay, yeah, he
so
went
going
there.
For that cap back nose. So paying attention to the score there, going, okay.
Yeah, and the pressure is also on for Giovanni. He has to land the next trick to get two scores on the board in this section.
This is it, man. This is the cooker right here.
We are back to our current leader, Nyjah Huston. Going
half cap kick flip nose.
Yeah, half cap flip nose slide.
I mean, at this point, to be honest, I think he's sitting pretty good.
Yeah, I mean, but you can never get too comfortable. Yeah. I mean, he's a clear 5 points
ahead. You never
ahead,
know. Yeah, you never know.
Top the order. Fifth and final trick attempts here in the finals from...
So we are on to our final tricks of our men's street final here in Lausanne, Switzerland. Fifth and final trick attempt is going to be kicked off by Richard Turi from Slovakia. It looks like he's in position for that kicker to hover.
Yeah, and you hear that crowd just erupting. The crowd out here in Lausanne has been so amazing.
Let's see this, Richard. Oh, you can see he's trying to catch it into the 5-0.
So, yeah, heel flip barrel 5-0. Is that what he's trying there?
Yeah. Awkward trick because you've got to get that board around without it hitting the ledge. You've got to get some good pop. And like we said earlier, that obstacle is not inviting.
No. Bump to steep hover.
So Richard staying in that fourth place position at the moment as we take it over to Toa Sasaki from Japan.
Currently in second.
Yeah. He's going to want to increase that, though.
He wants to top Nyjah. Okay.
Oh, you could see there. Maybe he was going to go big spin.
Yeah. There's cab, back nose, what big spin out attempt.
I mean, at that point in the competition, if you know what's going on, if you know what could come up as well, especially knowing that Yuto is going for that nollie heel flip 270 board.
Yeah, great showing from Toa.
So, Yukito Aoki, I really, really want to see this last trick. It's all on the line here. Last attempt to get that second score on the board. Whoa! There you go!
Nollie big spin heel back lip. Do they dock him for the hand down?
No, do you know what? If it does, it's not going to be much, surely, because just from the hardness of that trick. Yeah. So, so gnarly. And, you know, fair play to him. He has had the whole weight on his shoulders, knowing how important it is to get that last trick done. Composed himself. Nollie heel flip, big spin, backside lip slide.
I would say he really shines in the run section because he feeds off flow.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, for sure.
And I think that it seems like the best trick is almost more difficult for him.
Yeah, possibly.
I mean, you know what I mean? Because he's got such great flow through the course.
So currently in that seventh place position. All eyes are on the board right now. You could hear a pin drop out here in Lausanne.
Currently in seventh.
Waiting for that score to drop. He's definitely got those judges working hard. 88.55 season jump up and knock Richard Turi off that fourth place position.
Yeah, I mean, points wise.
Okay, le prochain sur la liste. Allez, on aimerait bien voir ce trick.
Point size, that is great for Yukito.
Yeah. Okay, we are back round to Kairi Netsuki. Let's see this, Kairi. Last attempt to get the second score on the board. Okay, playing it safe, doing doing the heel flip, okay, backside tailside fakie.
I arguably think he wanted a big spin but didn't land properly. It's hard to say, you know?
Yeah, I mean, we mentioned it yesterday. Skateboarding time during a trick slows down.
Yeah.
You can make adjustments on the fly within a millisecond. And maybe he was like, nah, foot's not in the right place or the board's not sliding on the tail enough. I'll just take it to fakie and get that score on the board. Yeah. Or he may have dropped in and gone, I'm not going to big spin out. Because that's a heavy trick as it is.
True story. I've always been a heel flip guy. And I did that trick once on a curb.
Yeah.
In like 1995. And I was like, done. I can't believe I did that.
Yeah, we'll leave it there. I won't go back. It's so hard.
It was like a 5-inch high curve, though.
But did you think we'd be seeing it on 9-stair handrails?
No. No.
89.07.
Okay.
Wow.
Third position for Kyrie.
And next up, nice, we have out of Japan,
Yuto
Horigome.
Currently not on the podium.
Do you think he's going to go for something that's super difficult for everyone else and easy for him? Or is he going to go all in and try and get the nollie heel in?
He's going all in. I think he's going all in.
Here we go. Oh, no. Changed it up.
Okay. Switching it up a bit.
Such an awkward trick. That is so, so gnarly. Yukito Horigome coming through. Even Nyjah just shaking his head. He's like, no.
What is that?
You don't want to do that. So he's got the 75.41 on the board. And joining that at the moment, the 92.33, 96.95.
Those best trick scores, man.
Yeah.
That's where he really shines. And I think the run section counting kind of, unfortunately, counted it against him a bit.
Yeah, and I mean, is he going to be able to drop the 92 score?
Look, okay, so that's like a nolly back that is. 180.
Into the switch
into
front
switch
side Smith.
Yeah.
I mean, try and work that out at home. Start thinking about getting your feet in that position. And which way are you looking again? Am I looking under my arm, over my shoulder? Which way am I spinning? Crazy.
Proper. Okay.
90.81.
Okay.
So not dropping that 92.33.
That will be it for Yuto Horigome. Will not be on the podium, but respectable skating as always.
And we've got our top three remaining. We're taking it back to France next for our for the fifth and final trick.
Yeah, Aureliano's just going for points at this time. He's not going to podium.
And knowing him, he's going to just try and get this trick done. He won't be beat.
What?
There it is! Wow! If you're going to do it, you're going to do it that good. And if you're going to save it for the fifth and final trick, you're going to do it that good as well.
So hard flip back 180.
Over the rail.
Yeah.
So
I love that he went back to it. Because that's like a skateboarder right there.
Definitely. That shows that skateboarder mentality where you're like,
I'm not going to let this trick defeat me.
No. I mean, to get good at skateboarding, you definitely make friends with failure, but you also are so determined and can't leave certain tricks alone.
Yeah, well, this is all leading up to Rome 2024, right? So it's like everything counts. The difference between 10th and 8th, 8th and 6th, 6th and 3rd, it all counts.
Yeah, and I mean, to get through to the final, you're in that top 10 scoring, and you're getting some heavy, heavy points. 93,
wow.
Huge score. But
only jumps
down
up in a seventh. We wish we would have seen more lands. But hey, amazing skateboarding for Rayssa, as always.
But the pressure's now on with Giovanni Viana, who's currently in that eighth place position. He's our next rider up. All the pressure is on that fifth and final trick for him. Here's one more time. Here's that other
Boom,
view.
Look at that. You Whoa, called
you
it over the rail.
And
give
tell
away
you what,
a setup.
To land it fast enough, it shows how smooth it was because he got out onto the platform of an 8-foot quarter pipe.
I gotta say, I'm always amazed when skaters hand out their setup because I'm so picky about my trucks.
Yeah, it's the bushes.
I hate
for me.
New setups.
Yeah. Okay, fifth and final trick for Brazilian Giovanni Viana.
Get it, Giovanni.
There
okay.
it is, and it's perfect.
Okay.
I would say that that was better than the previous version that we saw, right?
I would say so. Giovanni. The crowd's erupting.
Yes.
Brazil in the house.
So 179.06. Really needed that to get higher up that leaderboard.
Brazilian crew is stoked. Definitely going to jump him up from eighth place.
There's that replay. So coming in Fakey, which is backwards, taking it all the way over the rail, 270 into that backside nose blunt slide and through to Fakey. Slid it way better, I think, and rode out better than we saw previously.
Yeah.
So, but it will be a similar score, I think. Gabby first, got her eyes on the board there.
First became aware of him at, just in the audience of a Vans Park Series event. Almost a decade ago, and someone pointed to him like, this kid is the future.
Yeah, and he really is. Sure 89 enough. Coming through there and seeing him jump up into that podium position. Team Brazil are super high
amazing.
Right now.
Amazing. Wow. Wow. I think he went from eighth to third?
Yeah.
Wow.
Heavy.
Wow.
But he didn't have that last score on the board, so getting that in there is so important. So current leader... He's already in the first place position. He's already won this thing. We have the amazing Nyjah Huston.
Ah!
Not quite getting it done, but 90 in the run section, Chris. 92.71 on the board as well.
Yes.
Wow, wow, wow. And then that 93.23. Nyjah Huston is still... absolutely smashing it,
dominating on top of the game.
You see Yuto running in there, giving him the hugs.
Our only USA competitor draped in the flag.
There you have it, our winner of WST 2023 Lausanne Switzerland Street goes to Nyjah Huston.
I'm super proud of him, man. All these new names coming up in the game, how difficult everything's getting to maintain the lead as long as he has is unbelievable.
Yeah, but it's almost like people are catching up to him, right? Do you know what I mean?
But then he
like
moves.
Like with Tony Hawk, people slowly caught up.
He moves ahead, though.
Yeah, that's
when that
the
happens.
Thing. Yeah, that's what I was going to say. He'll then go, oh, okay, here's this trick that no one else has seen either. So our final standings there, Frenchman Aurélien finishing with that 212 and down in eighth place. And then in the middle of the pack, we've got three Japanese skaters, headed up by Kairi Natsuki. And then Giovanni jumping way up on that last trick attempt into the third position. Towa Sasaki in second, and again, Nyjah Huston in that first place position with 275.94. So it's time to jump back down course side to Samantha Bruce with our winner, Nyjah Huston.
Nyjah, congratulations. I mean, we talked yesterday and you said you weren't going to go easy. And I mean, look at you now, first place again.
Yep, it's a good one. It feels great. It feels good to go out there and, you know, not only land hard tricks, but just like feel solid on your board. My first round was a little sketchy, but I was able to clean up the next one. And then to be able to put down your first tricks and just kind of get that pressure off of you, it's a great feeling, man. I'm so stoked.
I mean, dare I talk about it, but there seems to be a bit of a battle between Japan and America. I mean, is it a friendly battle? Talk us through it.
Yeah, I mean, I think it's always a friendly battle with us skaters out there. And no matter who it is, no matter what country it is, like, for the most part, we're all homies with each other. Someone lands a sick trick, you always see us give props because we're just hyped to see good skateboarding. And that's what it's all about. But yeah, I'm proud that I'm out there representing for the U.S. because I was the only one in the finals. But we got a couple other guys, too. Hopefully next time we'll see Braden and Jamie and the homies in there. So USA, baby, let's go.
Awesome. And congratulations and good luck for the next comp.
Thank you.
Thank you very much, Sam. He is stoked, and rightly so. Put on a great show today, Chris.
Yeah, yeah. We called it earlier friendly fire. There's a love between the skaters, but there's a lot on the line. And it was interesting to see Costin's mind blown.
Yeah.
When we were talking to him. You know what I mean? With the level of difficulty, because... I mean, arguably, Eric is one of the people that started this level of difficulty.
Exactly. Here's our highlights from our men's finals. Third place, Giovanni Viana.
I love that fakie ollie hurricane. That's just such a unique, awkward trick.
And that's where we saw him change it up with the Nolly Big Spin backside lip slide. And it was great to see that competition experience of, I need to change my run and wow the judges to step that score up.
Yeah, and that cab to frontside nose slide, so difficult.
And there's talking about difficult, that one, frontside half cab, yeah. Backside Smith grind.
Wow.
And I mean, he's got such a good fakie game. And this is another example of it. All the power in the final hour. Cab, Alerial, backside nose slide, nose bun slide.
Yeah, land perfectly.
So second place, we have Toa kicking it off with that backside nose blunt slide, and that backside 360, it's literally super glued to his feet, right?
This kid's got amazing style. Bigger flip front board, you see the psych on his face. Only 16 years old, walk away with second place.
And then that Nolly barley grind 180 out. And then came through.
Yeah, the cab back nose blunt fakie. Under rotated, but hung on to it when it mattered.
Yeah, and I mean, knowing at that point it was all or nothing to stay up there. And here we have your first place winner, Nyjah Huston. Kickflip backside lip slide every go. I don't think he fell off that one time the whole weekend.
I mean, yeah, I love to see Nyjah smiling out there. It seems like he's having a ton of fun these days with skateboarding, recovering from a gnarly injury. So, yeah, impressive, impressive win.
You see his face there riding out. He was so, so stoked. And then Nolly heel flip, nose blunt slide.
That sealed the deal. You're like,
and
game
it was
over.
Perfect. Literally
game
perfect, Chris.
Over.
And you see his face there. So, so hyped. Well, there you have it. What an amazing competition. So, so good. And our next street competition will be our World Championships in Tokyo in December.
I can't wait.
It's going to be so good. And I mean, this is just an insight. We're talking World Championships. Things are going to step up another notch, right?
Yeah, and with the Japanese field dominating competition, they're going to be on their home turf.
Yeah, and I want to see the return of Sora Shirai, because we were missing some big names, Chris.
Yeah, unfortunately out with an injury. I'm sure we'll see him back.
Yeah, and I mean, that's going to mix things up, because we've got this fight, that, you know, final fight to get points towards the
Road to Paris,
yeah. 24. And I mean, we've also got further competitions coming up next year in Sharjah again. But it's all going to be down to that World Championships in Tokyo in December. So our next competition is going to be Rome. It's going to be a banger. It's our park competition. You definitely don't want to miss it. 7th and 8th of October, and it's our second park stop of the year too. There's Jagger Eaton.
Yeah, one of the only competitors that can win a street competition and a park competition.
Yeah, and he's going to want to hold on to that title as well, Chris. That podium was an incredible competition last year. Chris, this has been an amazing competition yet again. You can see there Nyjah signing people's phones.
Yeah, I've had a blast, man. I mean, you know, like we heard from Eric Costin, just the level of skateboarding, the technical difficulty, the consistency, it's just getting better and better every competition, really.
Yeah, but can Nyjah maintain that lead as we go through to our World Championships, Chris?
He's done it for a good 10, 15 years, you know what I mean? I would not bet against Nyjah Huston in any betting game.
No
on skateboarding.
Way. I can't wait to see it, and I hope you guys can all join us again. Thank you very much for joining us for our finals. Chris, it's been a pleasure to be in the booth with you again,
much
buddy.
Much love, brother.
It's Thank you fun. Very much, and we'll see you in Japan.
Go, make what you you won't, take what you won't, ay. Take what you won't, say what you wanna say. Just another day, to decide if this the game you wanna play, wanna play. Make what you won't, take what you wanna, ay. Take what you won't, say what you wanna say. Just another day, to decide if this the game you wanna play, yeah. Spit it into the tape clip. Get a grip, we lift up, no spaceship. A part of me, keep rhymes in harmony like take six with lines you can't fix. Face first, this verse give you a facelift. It's an art when I start, the paint drips from a canvas. You asking, I got the answers. The only one to give it, I only spit it with passion. Make what you won't, take what you won't, ay. Take what you won't, say what you wanna say. Just another day, to decide if this the game you wanna play, make what you won't, take what you wanna, ay. Take what you won't, say what you wanna say. Just another day, to decide if this the game you wanna play, wanna play.